You know what that sound means, Ryan?
It's time for Ludum Dare games.
Beep, beep. Look out. We're on the train for fun.
Yeah.
All right. This should hopefully all be live streaming now and working. My name is Matthew.
And I'm Ryan.
And welcome to Matthew and Ryan play Ludum Dare games from Ludum Dare 35. Presented by Hopped Up Gaming East, a podcast you might listen to or go to their YouTube page to view this archive later. Ryan is the number one fan of the show.
Yeah, I'm the number one fan. I never listened to it, though.
Ryan, put your damn headphones on so you can actually hear me and the games.
All right.
Okay, well, I don't know how many people have joined us. I can see there's a red person there with a number next to them, so that means somebody's watching. Why don't we get to the main event? What everyone's here to see. Video games.
Yeah.
So quick history here. You and I have made a couple Ludum Dare games.
Yeah, I mean, if you go to my profile.
Oh, God, you're
bring it up here, like on the
things.
Fly here, improv time.
We're going to click that, and then I'm going to go over
then,
here.
No, just scroll down.
Oh, yeah, right. You have one.
I have a post.
Yeah. It
then,
is.
Oh, up.
Okay, up, then, right there.
And then click Ryan Nielsen.
There we go.
And then you, there you go.
There we go. These are the games we've done more games than this, but these are the ones we've made for past Ludum Dares. And what you see right here is the one that we submitted for this this little competition. It's called Mode Shift. We're not going to play right now. We're going to play your games. But you know, we would always love it to see more feedback on what we've done. So go give it a shot and see if you like it or if you hate it. And if you like it, tell us why. If you hate it, well, please kindly tell us why you hate it.
And I think Matt's got the high score of 72, 73 seconds.
Incorrect.
Oh, did you do better now?
We're going to just do this real quick. You know what? I've learned my lesson about trying to do full screen stuff. I have the current world high score of 100.92 seconds.
Which, take my word for it, that's pretty impressive.
Yeah,
I've gotten to maybe 50.
Yeah, you're terrible at it.
I'm pretty bad.
Anyway, we're going to close that there for now. Let's go back to that page here. We're going to close Mode Shift. Maybe we'll play that at the end or something. We got 10 games. We got 10 games we're going to go through. Yeah, or 11. 11 games we're going to go through. No, 10.
No, that's 10. So we have a list of 10. And if anyone's in the chat that hasn't submitted their game, just post a link in the chat and we'll try to check it out. We kind of want to...
don't want to go forever.
We don't want to go forever, but we also, if you're in the chat, we want to check out your game so we can give you live feedback. So just post your game in the chat.
Yeah, and let us know if the production quality is okay or bad or whatever. If the audio is not good or too loud, too quiet, just let us know and we can adjust that all on the fly. I think everything should be okay-ish for now, but always let us know. So, first up on that list there is Oh, What a Night by Siegfried Games. Or Siegfried...
Crows.
Crows?
Yep.
Submitted by... DSC 11. Ryan, have you looked at any of these games yet?
I downloaded them.
Okay.
that's about all I've done.
All right, so you're ahead of me then. I know nothing about this. Let's take a quick gander at the screenshots, then we'll read the text, and then we'll crack it open and start. You already extracted them. Do I need to install any of these games? Or
No, they should all be just executables.
Perfect. Okay.
Fingers crossed.
So looking at this real quick, I think I can take... can detect a small inspiration.
Just a tiny one,
just
maybe.
Just a tiny one. It might just be a little inspired by Pokemon on the Game Boy.
Looks great, though.
Yeah, that looks nice.
They nailed that look.
That's really good. Like it. And you got your text here, all kind of nice and clean. And let's have a little read of this content here. I don't know if I should read this aloud for the audience. I guess, like, to fill air, I should. But
yeah,
like,
yeah, go ahead.
One night you can't sleep and decide to take some sleeping pills. Oh, boy. What happens next was unexpected. This is the first Ludum Dare, so it's an adventure game, Game Boy style.
Okay.
Parentheses Pokemon. absurd story, no audio. Okay, that's fine. It's always hard to get audio in projects because it's usually the last thing.
Yeah,
because
that's what we have the most trouble with usually. It's kind of, you want to get it in early, but you want to also do everything else.
Yeah. Controls. Okay, we got the arrow keys. So I got the keyboard over here.
All right.
With its limited range. So I'll try and make this work. Space to interact, escape, hold to quit. Okay. And post-GM version.
Yeah, it's fine.
What does that mean?
Fix some bugs.
Oh, okay, okay. Fix confusing text. Most objects are interactable. Okay. Well.
Cool.
Where did I put that folder?
I don't know.
On my desktop. And then, right over
there. We're pretty professional here. There we go.
Right there.
So I ordered them in, they're numbered, so.
Good. All right. Well, let's start it.
All right.
There's no sound, so I don't have to worry about that. Oh, God. I hope this does not break.
This is the hard part.
You know what? I'm going to just
do. Are you doing windowed?
I'm just going to do windowed.
Max it out?
Yeah.
Full screen window?
Is there a way to do like 1080 window?
Well, you can't do 1080 because the window frame's taking up space. So that's probably 1080p minus window
frame. Okay. You know what we're going to do? We're just going to do 1080. And Ryan, you watch the monitor there and tell me if this thing breaks.
This is a live test.
If it's a black window or a white window or the game. Yeah, unfortunately, I was having trouble earlier with... Oh, that, hey, I like... Ooh,
yeah, that's
hey,
pretty nice.
This is nice. Good Lord, I hope that shows up on the window there.
I hope so, because it was nice.
Okay,
it's almost there.
We'll talk here for a second just to make sure this is working, because if it's not gonna... Yeah, the delay is big on this. I was trying to get this to... Oh, is it going on?
I think it worked.
Oh, hang on. That's just the Unity splash screen. That doesn't mean anything.
Maybe the... Yeah. Oh, okay. We're good.
All right. We're good. I was trying to get YouTube streaming up, but you screwed that all up, Ryan. So, anyway, we're going to go with this. YouTube streaming seemed to have a way better delay for interacting with the audience in terms of the buffer on the video. So, okay. Press start. It's a keyboard and mouse game.
I don't remember the keys.
Interact? Okay.
I can remember the keys up here on my laptop, because then we can...
One night.
Look over.
I will say this. Don't put... Press start. On the title screen, if it's a keyboard.
I think they were going, trying to evoke the game.
I know. All right. One night. I'm sorry, I forget. Is there mouse control? There's not, right?
No.
Okay. Okay, I can't sleep.
Arrow keys are walking around, by the way.
Okay. Maybe I should try one of those. Sleeping pills. I got the other. Okay, keyboard's already.
Come on, keyboard.
Day. Now, where did I put them? I'm going to have to play like this. This is going to be uncomfortable.
Arrow keys.
Oh, arrow keys, right. I was trying to use WAD, sorry.
So it's arrow keys and space. Okay. That's all you need, really. All
right, then that's not so bad. I'm comfortable now. It's just a random painting. Oh, see, this is a... Can I talk to that? It's a phone book.
So I think you want your pills so you can go to bed.
See, I like this. He's not on a grid. It's free moving.
Oh, nice.
But why do I have all these bookshelves? See, that's nice. That's nice that you can, like, go around, touch everything, and interact with it. Here they are. Let's take one. Gulp. All right. Now back to bit. What's happening? Why does it hurt so much? Oh, dear. Make it stop. Do you think this is going to be a narrative-focused game, or is this going to be, like, a weird, like, you know, Froggy Fractions kind of thing where we're going on a big adventure that's...
It's hard to
say.
Not
predictable.
They said there was an absurd storyline, so we'll see.
Okay. This is ridiculous. I want my money back now.
Okay.
I don't know that your first concern should be money when you're a cat. Yeah. All of a sudden. Okay, maybe cats are good at sleeping, but now I'd rather play and eat mice, any mice around. Okay. Can I still interact with... Okay. Really? Where'd you go? Food go? Well, let's go over here. I'm going to try and not get myself carpal tunnel with this setup. It's so dark out here, even for a cat. I should find a way to turn on the lights. Let's go. Is this it? That doesn't work. Okay. Are these doors down here?
Can they I look go? Like it, yeah.
I can't get it open. It's just too dark.
Yeah. You probably want to turn a light on.
Yeah, but what's this? The plant? Trying to... Well, let's go up here and take a look for a light. Is that a light thing? I can't get it. Just too dark. Okay. So I probably can't use
that. Cats have good night vision, don't they?
Yeah. That's nothing there.
There's a switch right there.
That's the same thing as the... That doesn't work.
What about over there on the wall to your right? See that little black notch? Okay, never mind. That's nothing.
That's just a black notch, Ryan.
All right.
Okay, hang on a second here. I feel
all the doors?
That there's a puzzle that I'm missing here. Let's go back here. Is there a flashlight or something I'm supposed to bring? There's nothing in here, really. Where did it go?
Go to bed?
yeah, why don't I go to bed? I'm not sleepy anymore.
Okay.
Okay.
Let me just try all the doors.
Could.
Yeah, try every single door.
Okay, it's too dark. What is this big thing?
It looks like a couch or something.
All right.
Yeah, every door. I think this is the key.
I tried this one.
Yeah, we did that one.
I tried that one, I think.
Yeah, that one's...
And that plant did nothing.
Apparently doors don't open in the dark.
Maybe... No, sorry, this doesn't work either?
No, I think... just try every door.
Okay. Well, I can't get it.
The chat is saying to try all the doors.
Okay.
I think we should try them.
Plant. Boy, this really is an unpredictable.
There we go.
What? Okay.
Oh, there's a. Yep, that's probably. There we go.
Now that's better. Let's continue on our search for mice. Hey, well, you know what? Look, it's a mouse hole. Wonder where it leads to. Food. That's where it leads to. It contains a lot of cool stuff. No inventory. All right. Makes the game easy. No inventory.
Keep trying the other... Oh, there's another mouse hole.
That's that notch you found earlier. Same thing.
Okay.
Well, let's...
So you probably want to turn to a mouse, I'm guessing.
Door seems to be locked. I'm wondering if it's my computer or not, but like it almost feels like... it's chugging a little bit.
Oh, really?
Some spots.
Yeah, I see.
Yeah, you see, it's getting a little framey there. I wonder if that's my computer.
Might be because you're streaming, but your computer's not underpowered.
No, I've... Oh, okay, cool. Whoa. What's this?
You're in space.
Can't click on anything here. I like the star background. That's nice. That's well made.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, what'd this say?
It's probably an elevator.
There's a note on the elevator. This elevator should not be used by cats.
There you go. So I'm going to guess we have to turn into a mouse, then somehow turn back into a person, and then use the elevator and leave.
Maybe. Does this door do anything? Oh, boy. It's like Silent Hill. All you do is walk around and touch doors.
And then every door is locked.
And every door is locked. Okay. There's nothing in here, really. Where did all the food go? It's just like my fridge. Do I want to sleep in this bed? Not sleepy. Okay. What did the character say as soon as I became a person or a cat and turned the power on? Would it say like, "Oh, I've got a..."
Well, he wants to find mice, and then you tried to look at the mouse hole, and it said he wants to go inside of it. I think like, how would I get inside of it? Which makes me think you have to turn into a mouse somehow.
Now let's go back here and. I didn't look at the thing next to this. No.
This is like those old games on the PC back in the day, where you just click every pixel on the screen until you find what you want.
Yeah. Hey, chat, do you have a strategy guide for me?
The developer's actually in here, so what do we do?
What do we do next?
We're done. We don't understand.
We've obviously missed something.
So you should check the other mouse hole again and actually read. The one up there, probably in the hallway, I'm guessing.
Well, let's start with the first one here.
Okay.
Look, it's a mouse hole. I wonder where it leads to.
Okay.
Okay.
So the other mouse hole, that one to your left there.
Yeah, I just got to check one thing here.
Oh, you thought it might have went to
like, I thought it might have been like that room might have been unlocked now or something since we checked it earlier. Look, it's a mouse hole. Maybe there's... A mouse in the room behind this wall. I should find a way to get...
Okay.
So
we need to get in that door.
Can you
somehow.
Tell us how to get into...
what's that thing on the wall again?
It does not work.
Okay. So
we can try the other one.
Go up and around. Maybe you
can
go from the back.
Can I move this?
No, wait. Go in 33. Now, can we get into 34 from the right? Like, can we move that chair?
I don't think so. Nope.
Okay.
Can I go in the oven? This is no time for cooking, Ryan. There's nothing here.
Okay.
Nope.
So let's go to that room from the right, I guess.
Well, it seems weird that this room exists at all. There's obviously something that you got to do with it. But
I mean, it might come back later. Who knows?
Yeah. Well, we need another hint.
Yeah. Just keep telling
We're
us.
Idiots.
Keep telling us what to do. we have a limited amount of time. We want to check it out.
I like the look of it.
No, it looks awesome.
Yeah.
Nailed it. Just yeah, click along that wall, or like, is there a hidden door?
Maybe no. This is that room again.
Like, just go along the wall to the left and just mash the button.
How about is it here? Is it here? What's this plant? No, it's no interest to me.
It's in room 33.
I told you.
No, I said go there, but we didn't find anything.
Okay.
I figured it'd have to be that chair, but you checked the cupboards, right?
One side of them. There's nothing here. There's nothing here.
Okay. There's nothing in the stove. The window?
I can check the window. Hang on. Let's open this window and have a look outside.
Of course.
There we go. This would be room 34, probably.
That's a side-scroller.
This is room 34. Nope. This is room... Nope.
That window's open. That's probably a sign.
Yes, that's it.
So this is probably room 34.
Room 34. Welcome. There's a box on that fridge. Nope. Hey, mouse. Wonderful. I got you, silly mouse.
Oh, now you're... Okay, so go back to that room.
It doesn't make any sense. I'm still hungry. I want cheese.
Okay.
So that's my objective.
So now you can go through the mouse hole. All right.
Yeah, so now I'm going to go down here, and I'm going to go in the mouse hole. Hey, I like these. I like this dirt and this rock thing.
Yeah, that's nice.
Two little sprites here. I like those.
This whole thing looks super nice.
Yeah, that's always the thing I have trouble with. I guess we should have said what we've done on our games. I do usually art and sound stuff, and you usually do the programming.
Yep.
The thing I always struggle with is trying to do dirt. Dirt is hard because like
you don't want it to repeat.
You don't want to repeat too much, but like obviously there's only like two sprites being or three, I should say, being used here to represent the dirt, and it's like no, it communicates well. Key, I'm the magical key, and I'm in a good mood, so I'll open all the doors for you.
Oh, geez.
Now I'm a key. I bet. All right, my job here is done. See you in some other game.
So it's just a sentient key.
Yep.
All right.
So I assume now I'm gonna go poke some more doors and find some cheese.
One room we didn't check? Maybe two?
There's the elevator.
Oh, wait. There's all the rooms that are like downward facing as well.
Yeah. I got a feeling those ones aren't going to open.
Probably not.
Whatever. Okay, let's try room 35 real quick. It's still locked. The magical key lied to me. What a dickhole.
Wow.
There's a phone.
Any cheese in here?
No need to call anyone right now.
Check the fridge for cheese.
I'm not hungry and sleepy. Okay. I'll go to the fridge. Although it might be just like one of all the other fridges where it's like, where's the food?
Oh.
Where's the cheese? Where is the cheese? Hey, oh, magnifying glass. We're looking for things. It seems like someone is investigating the secret within the building. It has something to do with the fridge and the painting.
Okay.
Maybe it'll lead to cheese. All right.
Fridge and the painting.
Now, hang on. I'm going to go back and read that again just to make sure I know what I'm looking for. Investigating a secret within this building has something to do with a fridge and a painting. Okay. So I'm looking for a fridge or a painting or something. And that fridge did nothing. Let's go. We've been to 34 and 35. Let's check out these rooms down here.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy. I think something went wrong here. Yeah. Certainly looks
like a test room. Just testing all the objects.
Yep. That's
wait, was that in the...
Yeah, I was going to say... What's
that looks like a painting.
Yeah, nope. This looks like a sprite sheet, if I've ever seen one. Not supposed to be in there. That door's supposed to stay locked. Here's a fridge. There's nothing in
that
here.
That painting looks unique.
It does. What is this? Oh, it's just a painting. At least I think so. Hey, see something beneath it. It's a switch. Let's try and press it.
Oh.
Ryan, your phone is vibrating.
It does that sometimes. I'm popular. What can I say?
Put it in your pocket.
Okay.
Hey, look. Cheese. I knew it would lead to cheese. God, please don't make me be cheese.
Oh, no.
Fantastic. Now I'm cheese.
So how much longer is this? I mean, I like it, but...
Yeah. You know what? I feel like I was being... pizza. Let's go do that.
So we thought of pizza now?
Oh, man. So many things to do. Speaking of so many things to do, I think we might have to move on to another game here in a second. Unless we are like just at the end of it or something. I feel like this room is yet to be used.
Yeah.
And this is the end room or something. I do like the cheese hopping animation. Boing, boing, boing.
It's nice.
Where else could we... we haven't checked
our main room. Is there like a pizza in there?
No. Oh, that was the investigation room. No, there was no pizza in our room that I remember. There's no pizza here. But we can call for pizza. Could order pizza, but I don't know what number to call.
That's a good idea.
I'm on the same wavelength as the developer here.
You guys think alike. You should be friends.
Yeah. This is that room we became cheese in. In 33, there was no...
Somebody in chat said this game has a cheesy plot.
You know, I think it's full of holes, to be honest.
Oh.
Oh.
Stop it.
Yeah, I'm not sure where else to go. Unless I'm forgetting something.
I don't know. I haven't seen cheese.
Okay.
We can just call it.
Yeah, I think we've... It's still locked. Yeah. I bet it's what we're looking for. Oh, wait. Okay, let's try
one
last thing.
Somebody said there's a phone book.
Oh, for God's sakes.
So you look in the phone book to find the pizza number.
I thought it would be like, okay, go dial
so,
a pizza.
So, yeah, you were kind of right. That's probably the phone book?
The 69 book. I can use this phone book to look up pizza. Okay. Let's do this part. I got it. Now I just need a phone.
Okay.
Trust me.
We got this.
I know where the phone is this time. Yeah, I really wish this had some sound. I think that's that would add so much, and you know, have some fun with that. All right, let's call the pizza delivery service. Pizza delivery, please put me on one of your delicious pies. Hi there, I want some pizza now. Okay, thanks. Bye.
Wow, that was the most painless pizza order ever.
Now, where will my pizza be delivered?
Outside.
I bet
it's got to be out there.
I bet it's gonna be up here to space. Look at that. I ate the pizza, now I'm a pizza, I bet.
No, you cheat.
I'm a pizza. Oh. Yay, a pizza is always what I've wanted to be. Seriously, though, I'm so tired of this. Someone just eat me, please. Oh, my God. Oh, hey, look at that. That's a fun animation.
That's a good animation, too, yeah.
I like that one. Unfortunately, I think we need to call it here
yeah,
now.
Yeah, I think we have to. I like it, though.
Yeah, I like it, too. It's a fun little point-and-click adventure thing. You've gone to great lengths to make sure that this... this is not just a, you know, A to B to C. Like, it is A, B to C, but, like, there's, you know, you're hunting and rooting and searching. You get to know the space. I think it was Hold Escape to quit.
Yes.
There we go. Hey, that was elegant.
Cool. Yeah,
and, I like that. And the intro was elegant, too. Your little splash screens and stuff. So how do we do this, Ryan? How are we going to do our feedback?
So, yeah, if you scroll down here. So we can do feedback or scroll up. Are you logged in on this machine?
I don't think we're logged in as you.
All right. Can we turn the screen to black so I can log in?
You know what? I can do slightly better. We're going to do...
The stream might break here. Just
hold on. Good God. What did I just... Okay, hang on. We're going to go back over here just to make... Okay.
So we should be on standby now.
We should be on standby.
All right, hit log in there.
Here, I'm just going to pass the keyboard to you.
Okay. Oh, God.
I'm just going to watch the stream thing there.
It's not working. This keyboard is not working. Oh, there it goes. You just
right
do it
there
for me.
All right. Okay, yeah, it's up. What was I going to say? While you're logging in here, excuse me, so we can do the feedback. I forget what the categories and all that stuff are, but I usually don't like to... I really don't like the feedback system.
Matt is not a fan of the Ludum Dare feedback system.
Oh, I just absolutely hate it. Just because, like, there's certain precedents. There's a certain precedent set based on, like, the default categories are these. So, it's like, I think something that's bothered me a lot is that, like, humor is by default a category you're rated on. And I think you can opt out of it, if that... Am I correct?
Yeah, we've opted out of it.
Yeah, sure. Just because, like... By having that as a default, it just assumes that everyone's supposed to be making funny games. And it's like, some games aren't supposed to be funny, and some of them are, but they aren't, and some are funny, and they are funny. And it's just, I really wish it was all... I wish it was elective. Like, when you submit your game, it's like, what categories would you like to be voted on? Now, I didn't do the submission. Maybe that's what it is, but, like...
It defaults to all of them checked, but you can turn them off.
Okay,
sure.
Okay.
But it defaults to all of them checked, which causes problems, because some games which clearly aren't meant to be humorous, they leave it on there, and then you have to give it a one, because, I mean, it's not not necessarily funny, right?
But yeah. But then it's like that one drags everything down, and a zero isn't omitting it. It's just also a zero.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, wait, there's an NA now.
There's NA. Maybe that is
Nobody
just...
will ever pick that.
Yeah, no, they won't.
Yeah, and then I just breaking this down too, it's like I hate that it's a two-vector system here where it's like, that's the wrong term for it, but like you have an overall score and then you have a summary score basically, like of all these categories. So it's like, what do they pull? Do they pull the overall or do they pull a sum of all the bits? So I think we can bring it back up now. I think you've somehow... Yeah, faded to black on us.
I don't know.
Because you probably have a zero in one of your passwords or something.
Yeah.
And when you hit that button.
Maybe. Somebody in the chat actually says, he says, in his opinion, mood could specify so many different things that it's almost a useless
rating. Yeah, I 100% agree.
Because it's meaningless, really, because it can mean... Yeah, it can mean anything.
And then on top of that, like, yes, mood can mean many things in, like, the proper definition of it. But then in the, like... your peers are reviewing you kind of thing. Like most people probably don't know what mood specifically
is. Or they might think about mood as like, oh, it's dark and gloomy and
or it's sad. Is there sad out of
but
five?
Something could be happy and that's a...
Yeah, it's a stupid thing I think to make... It's not something you put a number on. It's something you talk about. Let's do this as best we can.
So... I guess we just go down the list. Well, skip overall, I guess.
Let's say up front, we're gonna make should we make the overall like an average of what we do. Everything else?
We'll just make it a rough average, I guess. That's the easiest way.
So, in terms of this is another thing, innovation. Are we supposed to be innovative?
Yeah, like what was your goal to be innovative?
Yeah, I'm gonna. I guess I'll put my live streamer hat down for a second and put on my criticism hat. Let's be critical but offer valuable feedback, you know.
That's what I want to do.
It seems like the objective of this was to make a little adventure game. They had a day or two days to make it. I think there's a thread there that you're following, you know, it's a fairly abstract, you know, little narrative of taking pills and going on a little adventure. Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas kind of thing, drug trip. So I don't know that it's... I don't think it's an innovative thing. It's just it's a walking around thing. It's not a creative exploration.
Yeah, it's not an entirely new idea.
But that doesn't... I don't think that was probably their objective. I bet they were just trying to get something made and get their story. What's up?
Someone's at your door.
Oh, someone's at the door? Okay, 1 second. Ryan, you take over.
Okay.
Oh, someone's already addressing the door. Let's take 2 seconds. We gotta address who's at the door.
Alright, we're back.
Alright, we're back. Oh, dang it.
Oh, now that makes
sense. We had house guests that needed to get in the house. So let's go back to this here quick. Innovation, I don't think that was the objective. The objective was getting something with a specific style and look and feel, probably more than anything.
Totally.
Not the funnest thing I've ever played. No. I like rooting around, but
it's probably a 3 or 4. Like it's good for what they went for.
I think. What was the theme?
So the theme was shape shifting.
This is another thing I absolutely hate. All right, shape shifting.
They shape shift. Well, I usually look at this as like a 3, as if like they did the theme.
Yeah.
Like in any way possible.
Yeah.
And then any higher than that is if they did something interesting with that idea.
You made a lot of animations, a lot of character models. You're changing through them, through your narrative. You've integrated that somehow. I think that's fine.
Totally.
Graphics.
I think they nailed the look.
Yeah. You're like, obviously 100%. Looking to do something like that Game Boy Pokemon stuff. So good job. You managed to emulate that quite well. And I liked your dirt. Sprites, the dirt rock sprites.
Matt got really fixated on the dirt.
Yeah. Hey. Humor.
It's probably like a 3.
I'm gonna say 3.
I didn't think it was super funny. Like I liked the story. It was quirky. And it played with the whole shape shifting idea in an interesting way.
Yeah. I'm just
mood. Yeah. 3 stars.
Or is NA? Can I?
I assume NA means the rating doesn't count. Good or bad, so maybe we just do that because I hate mood.
I'm just gonna
overall I'll be like a 4.
No half stars.
Awesome.
Okay, there we go. That's good. I really like, let's ignoring I'll go back and click that there in a second, but ignoring the things there, I think there it has obviously inspiration from Pokemon for its visual design. I do like it, though, a lot. Really would love some sound on this.
Yeah,
there's a lot of fun opportunity for your sound. You got, like, your fades to waves when you transform, like, wee, 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 or something.
Yeah, and just some chip tunes or little tiny bleeps and bloops when you...
Or some spooky stuff when you're hunting around as the cat or something.
But we totally understand that it's very hard to do that.
Yeah, totally hard. So,
and this is your first game, I think you said, so well done. Like, super good.
God, I don't want to write anything long here because we're already a little stressed.
Can we just hit submit? I don't think we have to write anything.
Good. All right. We'll just go great.
Yeah, just do great game.
Great, all
enjoy
capitals.
Playing it. Yeah, there
nope, we're just going to do single.
Okay.
Whatever. Oh, did that work?
I don't know. Yeah, we're good.
Okay, let's close that. So, yeah. Thanks for sharing that.
Yeah, thanks, Siege.
Right,
what do we got now?
What do we got now? We got Shapeshift.
Anjos.
I don't know.
Sure.
Let's read real quick. So we got some screenshots. So, how do you make animated GIFs?
Don't do that.
Oh, God. What
that plays the game. Refresh quick.
Okay. We're good. Screenshots.
Okay. So it's a little...
Animated GIF screenshots.
Neon-y. Oh, you can do that.
Oh, well, we should have done that for ours.
Yeah, probably.
Okay. This looks like something I've seen before. I can't remember what it's called. Standalone version recommended.
Yeah, so we can skip all these. They're just updates.
Updates. Where does it start?
You're a block of data wandering aimlessly through cyberspace. You have to get through each checkpoint correctly. Yep. It's difficult, but you can get a good score. So WS is up or down.
Mm-hmm.
Left click or space to switch shapes.
Okay.
Okay. Made it in Unity, so hopefully the full screen works.
Yeah. Okay, let's try it. Ryan, why don't you drive this one, see if the keyboard works for you.
See if the keyboard works way over here by me.
Yeah.
Wireless stuff is not always the best.
Drag that microphone over towards you. Okay. I'll see if I can get this going here.
So what was it? W and S and then space, I think?
It is W and S is or up and down.
Okay, I'll use up and down.
And then left click or space to switch shapes.
All right, cool.
Back over here.
Infinite runner, it looks like. Sure.
Yeah, please don't be a virus.
I always thought that Ludum Dare would be a good way to spread viruses.
Shut up, Ryan.
Not giving you guys any ideas or anything, but...
Well, let's make that go... Wait, boy. Oh, Christ.
Okay, we're in.
All right.
All right, let us know if the volume's good, if it looks good.
Again. Yeah. We are able to hear it in our heads. I can hear something. Title screen music or something here. It doesn't sound too loud, so I think we might be good on levels, but of course audience knows best, and we'll know for sure if that video is going through to you guys here in a minute.
Someone in the chat asked, where will this be uploaded to on YouTube? What's the channel?
This is going to be uploaded onto the Hopped Up Gaming East YouTube channel. It's a podcast I do with a bunch of friends, and Ryan is the number one fan of the show.
Yep.
Listens every week.
Every week.
So we wanted to use this account to just do some testing for video projects we've got coming up. So originally it was going to be archived and broadcasted through a YouTube stream, but Ryan put a different... different website up there. We're doing it on Twitch, so fortunately I get to test one thing today instead of two things. So yeah, just do a Google search for Hopped Up Gaming East and you'll find the YouTube channel where that will be archived. Okay, I think we've got confirmation that the stream is working. So yep. Ryan,
let's do this.
Let's cuddle up next to each other and shapeshift.
All right, so you have to use the mouse.
Here's a
pro tip. If your game just requires keyboard controls, it's great when you actually allow the mouse or the menus to be controlled by keyboard.
Yeah, just always good. Always good. All right. Well, we skipped the instructions.
Okay. Oh, did you?
What? Do I have to like click back in?
I don't. This keyboard might be messed up again. Oh, okay.
Okay, well, let me borrow the keyboard for a second there. Is it working now?
I think it's being a jerk.
Okay, right. Here, hang on. We're gonna switch.
We have a keyboard with no range.
All right, you move over.
All right.
So, like, I'm just gonna do it in my lap. Because
yeah, do it in your lap. That's fine.
Okay. All right, let's try this again. I'm gonna use the mouse.
All right. There's an on-the-fly switch.
I died.
Good job, Ryan. Music's nice.
How did I die there?
You didn't fit through.
But I... Oh.
No, you gotta be higher. Yeah.
It's very hard to. Oh God. Okay.
Is it? Are you just holding it and you're like dropping in chunks, or is it supposed to be smooth?
It drops in chunks. but it's very hard to gauge my height there, see? Because of the way it's coming at you, it's hard to tell. I got 3, though. That's pretty good.
Doesn't look that hard.
Boom. Boom. Ah. You do move a little slow, actually, as well, so... If you don't react immediately, it doesn't really ramp up.
Huh. Hmm.
It's kind of on.
It's an interesting perspective. Jeez, I've got to re-EQ this. I EQ'd you differently.
Thanks.
There, that should be a little better.
Professional outfit here.
Jeez. The perspective is interesting. It's crooked enough that like you can't like immediately tell. That I feel that one should have went in.
Well, it locks to positions, but...
Okay, you're really bad at this. Can I try?
There's a lot. Yeah. You want to try from there? It might not work.
Yeah, I'll make it work.
I
all
can
right.
switch for you if you want.
Nope. Just fire me.
All right.
Launch. Okay, nice. Let's try nice. Again. Let's try again.
Okay.
Oh, fuck. Okay, hang on. Okay, hang on. Hang on. Hang on.
So there were some post-jam versions of this, but we try to play the actual version that was submitted just for, fairness' sake.
Now, are those post-jam versions like ones with bug fixes? Or
you're allowed bug fixes, but that's about all you're allowed. Some people make post-jam versions
get fucked,
that
Ryan.
Have additions and that change the game drastically to make it better. But the idea is not to rate those because they had the extra time to improve their game.
Okay.
Yep.
Internalize some feedback. Oh my goodness. Oh. I don't
this
know
is
that
tough.
I yeah, it's tough. I don't know that I like the perspective.
See what I mean? It's very hard to judge the height of the holes from this perspective. Like it looks cool.
I think that's why this perspective was chosen, just because it is tricky to gauge this correctly.
I might work more if say there was like 3 levels to snap to. There's just too much
granularity.
Too much granularity, I think, for this perspective.
Yeah. Except for that. I got that one. I know when it's in the middle, but I don't know how to return to the middle easily.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I'm thinking if there's 3, you can just hit up and then you're in the middle from the bottom. Like there's just a little too much granularity, I think.
That's a hard going at least right from the top to right to the bottom is hard.
At least for the difficulty ramp here. Like it doesn't ramp at all. It's just on from the first plate, basically, so.
You know what? There might actually only be 3...
There's only 2.
No, there might only be 3...
3 heights?
Yeah.
But it moves smoothly between them?
Yeah. Maybe smooth... Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Maybe that's what it is. So there's 3 heights, but it doesn't snap to...
It lets you, like, sit in a whole bunch of...
Yeah, light. Which I think is...
That's tricky.
It's tricky because it's hard to tell exactly. Like that one.
Yeah.
It was hard to tell.
Like, I knew I had to go back to the middle, but...
Yeah.
I kind of wish the background... parallaxed or moved or
that
something.
Might just be incredibly disoriented.
Well, I mean, yeah,
but
sure.
It would look cool.
Yeah, it's just like we're moving, I think.
I think that's the idea.
Yeah, it's always something to come back and work on. Just a little visual polish.
Oh yeah, and again, that might be in the post jam version.
Did you want to try this again here, Ryan?
No.
Fuck. All right, one more go. I think my best was 5.
You got 5. I got about 3 or 4. Again, you're better than me. Oh, yeah. There's definitely only 3.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of lining them up.
Yeah. Oh, there we go.
Cool.
Main menu. You got a title screen?
What's the credits?
I would have loved to have that down a little lower. I love our title screens and, like, our little transitions and stuff.
Matt obsesses over title screens.
Listen, it's the page of the... It's the part of the game where you you consent to a, you know, an engagement or something, and it's got to be, like, this big celebration. Like, we're going to play a game, and... It's got to do something.
And we spent a lot of time in our title screen this time around.
We did.
And we both like it quite a bit.
Yes. It's our
mode underscore shift.
Yeah, go check it out.
Go play it. Go check it out.
Well, I think we're stuck here forever.
Can you... No escape? All right, so the whole stream, we're just going to keep playing this.
Yeah, I guess I'll never stream another... Okay, wait, maybe it says something to... No.
It's just Alt F4.
Oh,
when in doubt, in-game jams, Alt F4 and hope it doesn't kill the stream.
Oh, thank God it didn't. We're still good. We're still running.
Perfect.
Sorry, I haven't been looking at this.
Switch back over?
Yeah, switch back over.
All right. I haven't been reading the chat because I've been on the other side of the table.
Yeah, sorry if the developer was there and screaming at us like, you idiots, you're playing on super hard mode or granular mode or something. I wonder if that was a very quick, easy game for you to make, or if that took you all the time.
That was pretty good.
Always curious to know how long it took people to make things.
And Mr. RGB in the chat, we are taking submissions, so if you just post your game in the chat, We'll try to check it out since you're here.
Yeah.
We can give live feedback.
Okay, let's get down to the down dirty here, I guess. Hey, good, they took humor off. So I think, I don't know, Ryan, do you want to lead this one or do you want me to lead the conversation?
No, you can go ahead.
Okay, so I guess we'll do overall last. So innovation, you know, again, I think all the same stuff we've said before about other games is in the game jams. It's not always a place of innovation, but more like, let's test an idea. Let's build to a goal, build a thing. So like,
exactly.
We'll just go down the middle for that one. Like, sure. It is, we're plugging things into holes. Yep. Fun.
It was,
you know, this is something that I also just, I hate this rating system so much. Like, you know, it's not that game's not fun. I didn't have fun really with it just because, like, I wasn't, like, thoroughly engaged and it wasn't, like, popping off and all that fun stuff. Like, it's totally fine. But, like, do I, just because I didn't have fun, rate it one?
You rate it how, like, you feel, right? And I kind of feel the same way. I'm kind of right down the middle. I mean, I think it could be improved pretty easily with faster movement speed, maybe snapping to the holes because it's very hard to line up. Maybe the perspective could shift a little bit. Like,
I think the perspective is fine. I think it's just like that control of like there's too much granularity between the three holes.
So the combination of the perspective and the granularity causes the issue, not necessarily just the perspective.
I think there's something you made an iOS game called Tunnel Run that handled this, I think, well, where it's that there are only, like, it's basically blocks were coming at you like Tetris pieces and you had to not be in the way of them as they hit you, and it was a first person corridor run, and you could tap the sides and rotate the perspective.
Yeah, you snap to the edges of the square basically. So.
Yeah, so there was no like in betweens that you could get hung up on and not fit through. It was just avoid, like go left, go right, go up, go down. Like that adds a lot to it. And then that point you can start scaling the difficulty with not like, oh, there's a lot of spots you can be to avoid stuff, but rather the patterns are more intense, like crazy to deduce where you got to be. It's going faster. You're getting more per second. And that's where like a lot of engagement and fun can come from, I think. So
for sure.
Similar thing could be applied to this, I think. We'll just go down the middle for it. No fun though.
Yeah. That's fine.
Theme, shape shifting.
They're shifting. I've seen a couple games like this.
Circle
in
your square. Yep.
Like we said, if it matches the theme or if it meets the theme, we'll put it in the middle.
I'm going to, I kind of like the psychedelic looking stuff. I like the look.
It could be a little
bit
better, but it was a good start.
Yeah, I like
it. My mood. Just do NA. We'll do NA for all these.
Okay, yeah, fuck it.
Because I hate that category.
We'll round it up, or round up or round down. What do we do? Round up?
Let's just be. No, let's round down. No, round. Three threes and then a four, so that's a three.
Okay, that's a three.
Yep. Put like a sentence in here.
Yeah. Okay. Well, why don't you type that, Ryan? I'll just try and express some thoughts. It's a fun, simple little game. I like it. But I think there's a lot of things to, you know, improve on there. Just like with the mechanics themselves, like get rid of all that granularity. Like it's one of those things of
this keyboard's breaking.
I know. if it's not to be used in a mechanical way, like if there's never a reason to be in between spaces, then why is it there? You know, get rid of it, and then you can start like focusing on like making being in the correct spaces more interesting, or like transitioning to the correct spaces from your current space, like you know, a trickier endeavor or something. If that makes sense.
No, I'm a firm believer in that the controls should never really get in the way.
Yeah,
the controls shouldn't be what makes it difficult.
Yeah, and anyone who says like Resident Evil is one of the best games ever because the controls are ass, and that's what makes it scary. It's like
I don't like
the
idea.
Not the right kind of scary. Yeah. It's like I'm flailing because I don't know which button I have to hold to bring up my gun.
I can't do what I want. Like that's not necessarily fun.
Yeah. But no, thank you for sharing that.
Thanks.
Let's move on to
Duality.
The next one, Duality, from Holy Black Cat. God, I'm worried one of these times I'm going to read the name wrong and just either butcher it or it's going to be something awful.
It happens.
So what was this called? Sorry, it was Duality. Let's see the screenshots. Ooh, Castlevania looking. Legend of Zelda looking. Zelda 2, I guess.
Yeah.
A little bit. And it looks like a platformer. Let's read this description and then we'll jump in. I'll play this one.
Yeah, go ahead.
I've been playing them all so far.
Yep.
Play as a girl with an unusual ability to be in two places at the same time. From your point of view, you are... Sorry, from your point of view,
You
as a single character are going to interact with two copies of the world shifted relative to each other simultaneously. Ooh, I'm not quite sure I understand that, but...
So the world shifts around...
There's two versions of the world.
Two versions of
the world? Yeah, okay. Yeah. Well, let's read the controls here. All of these are listed in the game except for F12. Okay. Toggle full screen. Okay. Cool. Toggle music. Hey, that's a good idea, maybe. Wands. Your fancy ability.
Okay. So that probably shifts the world.
Okay.
Up arrows jump. Left and right or move.
I've read this from the bottom up. What's wrong with me? All right. Left and right move. Up jump. Okay. And wads. Bugs. Report them. Help. I'm stuck. There's a video walkthrough. Okay. Well, we'll probably go as long as we can until we get stuck, and then we'll stop.
Yep.
How many people we got in the chat there, Ryan?
It looks like there's 8.
Yeah, that's fine.
And again, if any of you guys that are in the chat submitted your game, just let us know so we can prioritize it.
Well, crap. I don't know what this was made with, so we're going to hang out here for about 30 seconds and talk while we...
Did you hit F12?
No.
Oh, it just went full screen.
You just went full screen. So we'll see what happens. If it's a black screen, we'll hit F12. And if it's not a black screen, we'll go ahead with this.
Okay.
Duality... just up front, I will say this. This is a dark purple against... These are especially dark and a little hard to read.
I mean, it could be a little bit glare, too, making it worse, but it is...
That doesn't help, yeah. Can you see anything on the screen there, Ryan?
I see black, but again, the game's dark, so... No, it's just black.
Okay, I'm going to hit F12, and we're going to... Uh-oh.
Does F12 not work?
Hold on. I've been lied to. Oh.
Okay.
Well, we just got a thing there. Okay, let's try that again.
Okay, can we just maybe...
Let's start the
window
game.
Window capture?
Oh, wait. The keyboard might just not be range.
That's more than likely what's happening. Nope. Can you move? Arrow keys?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's... F12 doesn't seem to work. That could be in the post-jam version, too.
Okay. You know what I can do? I could probably... Hold on.
Technical difficulties. 1 second.
Hang on. Hang on.
It's hard to stream Ludum Dare games because they all behave differently and they all use different engines.
Fuck.
And they all have different resolutions.
Yeah. Okay. Let's just go into OBS and we'll just game capture. Okay. We'll run the game and then we'll...
Just capture it directly?
Yeah. Capture the window directly. So flip back out. Game capture. Ba, 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 ba. Selected application. Duality. Nope. Nope. Duality.
What did you have the game capture on originally?
I had it set to an F12 refresh.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's probably why it was breaking, because F12 for him is the same one I'm using to refresh. Okay, you know what we're going to do? We're going to just, real quick.
F11?
Yeah.
That's C.
I clicked F11.
Right, backspace.
Okay.
C.
That's a C, huh?
Hit F12.
Function F12. They're function F11.
Oh, maybe you need to hit function F12. That's why it wasn't working.
Oh, shit. Maybe. Okay. Oh, well,
I don't know. Whatever.
Doesn't matter. Going in. Here we go.
Hit function F12.
My hand's not...
there we go.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, that's your capture. So maybe...
All right. We'll give it a couple more seconds here. Live demo, folks.
They said hit Alt-Enter, but we got it.
Yeah, we got it. Sorry, just to get back to it real quick now that we know it should work perfectly fine here. Always great to use either an outline or just like color. Like I like this purple here is nice and easy to read. The darker one when it's not highlighted, a little trickier, but I'll just reach for controller. Sorry. All right.
So arrow keys.
Arrow keys to move and wads to use.
Jump and wads says use your power. Okay, they put some instructions in game, which is always nice.
Jump to... Okay. Proceed carefully.
I like the music. Oh, you just...
Oh,
you didn't proceed carefully.
You're dead. All right. I'll jump over that. Is this...
That's the winning. Oh, does it, like,
does get
brighter
as
you go near it? No, that's how you beat the level.
Oh, okay. Use wands to shift planes. Large displacement is dangerous.
Whoa.
Oh, whoa.
So go down now?
Wait. Let's keep.
So you can probably jump on those.
Let's see how crazy this goes.
Is the world going to disappear? Yeah. You died.
Oh, interesting.
Because you displaced too far. So you're like, so you're between the worlds, I guess?
So, fuck, that's me just being an idiot. Hold on. Okay, hang on.
Shift.
So wait, does the direction...
Oh. So you're moving the second piece of the world, and you can see as you move it, if your world becomes more like translucent, basically.
Yeah.
So do that, then you should be able to let go of the key. And does it go back?
Yeah, it's automatically going back.
Oh God, get up there.
Oh, wow. This is neat, this actually. Is cool. So I can...
So you can displace that, or you can displace yourself up and go between them, or God. You can do that.
Oh, wait, yeah. Move my...
Down and left.
Oh, no, okay, technically I am moving the ground up.
So go left?
Well, no, what I need to... Yeah, I need to bring make a this, and then shove that
jump
into
on
the
it.
Oh,
then
God.
Ride, then you can ride it up. Just hold up.
Ooh, neat. You know what? The only thing I would say here right now that would be... probably a better way to do it, rather than this be like this is like I have a distance I can separate the planes. I wonder if like a resource, like an energy resource or something, like you only get so much of this per level, would be better. You know what I mean?
Maybe that limits experimentation at that point.
Yeah. Huh. Okay.
So you and the endpoint are kind of between the planes, so you can see it kind of interpolating.
I can bring it
between
up to
you. There you go.
Oh God!
Don't
am
get
I gonna...
crushed?
I'm kind of curious what happened there.
Well, I think the point was with that one. Like, I have to get crushed technically for that one to be successful because it was stuck between the two things.
Whoa! All right, I didn't think that was going
to
kill you.
Yeah. Make sure that you never, unless it's supposed to be like a mimic or something, make sure you never make your like good things the same color as your bad things.
Also, it looks like it's in the background because it's behind the grass.
Yeah. All right. There we go.
Cool.
But that was a level teaching us that that's bad.
There you go. Well, yeah. So, oh geez.
Oh, look at that! I'm creating twice as many shots.
Really?
Yeah. Oh shit! I can't go back. But
oh well. So, okay. Huh. See, you shouldn't have to just actually go down. You're gonna kill yourself here.
No.
Nope, if you displace too far north.
I know. But I want to.
Oh geez. Wow.
Oh God, that's a gun. Oh God.
So you need? Yeah. There you go. Let it fall.
Whoa. Oh my God, my brain can't handle this one. All right, hang on. So what we want to do is we want to get up.
You have to like go up a level, then let it drop, then go up a level, then let it drop.
Yeah, but I gotta keep shoving him back in because it's not clear if he can shoot through the grass.
Oh, I think he can.
I think he can too, but let's try.
So yeah, like then make that jump, let it go down. Yeah, it's gonna be slow going.
All right, so let's shove him down here and see if he shoots.
He can shoot through that grass.
He can just hit me no matter what. Yeah. Okay. Let's give this a whirl. You know what I could probably
do? Yeah, this would be probably pretty cool. The chat's mentioning with a controller would be kind of weird. Like using both thumbsticks.
Yeah, I think that would be maybe a
brother's kind of.
Yeah, that might actually be an interesting control scheme for this. I'm finding my brain is not... you're not able to like handle the two wads pads super well. I get it. I get why.
Oh yeah.
Like how it mechanically works, but oh Jesus Christ!
Yeah. I also get why.
I also think that they should be flipped. I think wad should not be this.
You think?
I think
wad
should be the move, and the arrows is like displace the world,
or an option to just flip.
Or an option, yeah. Maybe there is an option. Since it's a Ludum Dare game, I'm going to assume there are no options.
That's generally the case, which I won't complain about that, because...
Yeah, it's hard.
It's hard.
Okay, I just keep making the same mistake, so let's...
Take your time.
Whoa. Yeah, I'm going to shoot him into the ground.
Yeah, so that shoots through the ground, which is kind of... Well, it shoots through... Okay, so it can shoot through the other ground that's not its own dimension. So if you move the... gun down, it can't shoot through its own ground, but it'll shoot through the ground of the other dimension.
No, it just seems to be shooting. Okay. So let's stop and...
So just pull yourself straight.
So I'm going to jump up, pull him
jump
down.
Jump and pull... Yeah.
Man, this is... I want to beat this level, because it almost feels like this is the last level of sorts.
You might be here for a while.
Why? Are they saying there's a lot of levels? In the
no, chat? No, but I'm saying you're going to be in this level for a while at the rate you're going.
All right, I'm going to move away from the mic for a second so I can focus. Ryan, keep talking.
Okay. I believe in you, Matt. You can do it. I kind of just want to listen to this music. I like it.
Duh!
I tried to be quiet so you could win, but...
No, I just don't know how... I'm obviously doing something wrong, because I'm never going to be able to jump between the bullets.
I just think you have to line them up. And he can't, though, because you're only moving one dimension. I should jump. Oh.
No, see? He'll shoot in both spots.
Yeah, this is tough.
We'll give it a couple more tries.
This is super cool, though.
Yeah.
I think this is probably one of the more interesting ones we've played today.
If we're going to use innovation as a... Fuck! a thing that we're rating, this is going to be something we can point and go, like, this is very innovative.
Yeah, people in the chat are saying they gave up on this level, too. Because the difficulty spike is insane.
Oh!
Oh, you suck! Aw, you were so close. Alright, one more try. This is it. All or nothing.
All or nothing,
you
baby.
You got this. You got...
What? Oh, I got...
The issue is you can't see the bullets when they're in the other.
No, I got clipped by the environment. That's what it was.
Oh, did you?
I got technically crushed.
Oh.
Because the bullets were no... I'm going to try one more. Because I feel that one I got robbed.
Okay.
Because this is not the problem. Environment crushing.
This does seem super confusing. Oh, quick. Oh.
I can't figure it out. It just, my brain goes to mush it as soon as it's like improvise.
So is this the actual last try?
Maybe. This is the actual last.
This is the last try?
This is the last. Okay, because we're here.
So just go straight up. Don't worry about it. Just go up.
Hang on.
You just have to dodge. Yeah. Up, straight up.
Hang on. I wonder if like making him pre-shoot would be useful in some way.
Yeah, but he shoots so fast. I don't think that makes a difference.
Ah, fuck. I'm dead. All right.
It was good.
Yes, I like that a lot, actually. Where is my mouse cursor? There we go. Well, I hit the X. It's going to do something.
Oh, it crashed.
Well, it crashed.
That's fine.
There we go.
All right.
Let's
pop this page back up.
Put this back up here. Hey, Duality. Good job, Holy Black Cat.
Yeah, it's awesome. I don't know if he's in the chat, but we're going to this.
Awesome. Where are we going?
Up. Wait, what? I got logged out somehow.
Oh, no.
I'll refresh the page.
Oh,
just refresh.
Okay, well. Okay, good. Whew. Saved ourselves some trouble there. Okay. Hey, look at that. They put innovation. Let's go ahead and give them 5.
No, give them that. That one's awesome.
Yeah. Really, really like that idea.
Yeah.
Not going to say I'm going to steal that for some things, but definitely will be inspired by it. I do like the idea a lot of like, that shifting the environment. I think I would love to see that blown out into a full game.
Yeah, you can do a lot with
there's
that.
A lot of interesting puzzle design you can do with that.
Did you think it was fun? You were playing.
I thought it was fun.
Yeah.
I thought it was fun. I had fun with that game. It was engaging. And
theme, tricky. I don't know. Because shape shifting is not what that game did.
No. Technically. Well, you know, so much. What would you give our game, Ryan?
Yeah, I know.
Let's give it a 3.
I'd probably give our game a 3 for the theme, too. Cause,
yeah. Because it's technically doing something that shape shifting is a stupid thing, too.
Yeah.
It did not.
The theme wasn't great.
I rarely like. For some reason, I really don't like Ludum Dare, but I like doing the things. graphics. So, if I was to be critical of something, it's that I think, the pixel art is a little all over the place in terms of, you know, consistency.
Yeah.
Like, we got things that have, like, shading and lighting. We got a player character that has nothing. There's gradients. This has a different density than, you know, this character or the grass or whatever. It's a fine look for it, I guess, but it doesn't feel like there's a cohesive thing like the first game we looked at, the one where you're mouse and cheese and stuff. What was that called? A Fateful Night or a something night. They had a very cohesive art direction, if you will. You know what? Clearly, you spent most of your time making this stupid idea work.
It seems very complicated.
Yes, it seems complicated to make this work. So I would say, now that you've got that down, you could probably go polish up your art, make it really cool, and you got yourself a nice little video
good
game
idea
there.
Here.
Yeah, so we'll just—I'll say 3.
Three's good. Audio, I liked.
It was,
I liked the
there
music.
There was a nice ambience.
The ambiance was good.
It wasn't anything mind blowing, but the ambience is good. Humor.
Yeah, I didn't.
We're gonna say
we're not gonna give games that aren't.
And
just remove any categories that you don't want your game to be rated for.
Hey,
it's only gonna bring you down.
Maybe don't make any
There should be no default categories.
There should be no default, and you can't submit
except
until
theme,
you
maybe.
Pick
theme. Should be
no, because you know what? I think it should be There are no categories selected by default, and you have to pick the ones you want to be voted in before you can submit.
Yeah.
That would make way more sense.
I think so.
Because it would stop you, and then you'd have to
like think. Humor, mood, whatever. I know.
Two threes, two fives.
It's probably a four.
I'd say it's a very commendable four.
Great game.
Well done. I'm going to write in here. Great idea.
Don't put capitals.
I love putting capitals.
One guy in the chat said, before we get started, what mics do you guys use?
Right now, I'm using two Audio Technica. Oh, shoot. Hold on. The number's there. 81 or 8. Audio Technica AT813As. They're XLR condenser mics. I think they're XLR condenser. They're XLR. Yeah, they got to be condenser. They're just plugged into a Behringer mixer that then is just going USB into the computer. So a little better than, you know, the average headset or Yeti Blues or things like that. They have a bigger, warmer sound. And are nice. I don't know what they cost. They're like probably $300 a piece or something. So Ryan, how do I get more games?
Just open up some more links there. Star Buddy.
All right, let's open three more. And these are going to open backwards.
Because that makes sense. Yeah. Well, I guess it makes sense that the most recent link should open first, but...
Yeah, but you know what? That's not what
I think I've already rated one of these. Yeah, I haven't.
Okay, I'm going to close this.
Yes, close that.
And then...
Which one was... Yeah, I think that was the order.
Okay.
Okay, we're good.
Cool. Any other questions in the chat, or...
Not right now that I can tell.
Okay.
Somebody posted a game.
Okay. Well, we'll collect those for now, Ryan, and we'll judge because we might be on a bit more of a timetable than initially thought.
Yeah.
So we'll definitely take them, and if we have time, we'll pound through them real fast.
Sure.
Star Buddy by Drazzle100. Oh, and yeah, just to remind everyone, anyone who's new coming in here, this will be archived on the Hopped Up Gaming East podcast. Sorry, the Hopped Up Gaming East YouTube channel. It's a podcast.
Do you know the URL?
www.youtube.com/HLN_N. Okay, well, I'll read the rest of it out later in the show. But if you Google Hopped Up Gaming East or just punch it into YouTube, you should get it. Okay, let's do this.
Oh,
what's that? What, you?
They have controller support.
Oh, they do? You're playing this one then.
All right, perfect.
Star Buddy by Drazzle100. A space traveler crashes on an alien planet and finds a shape-shifting friend named Buddy. With your newfound companion, you must make your way through... Uh-oh, typo. Through a strange land and find your lost ship parts while avoiding the local wildlife. Be nice to Buddy. He's all you got.
Cool. So A is jump, RB is punch.
Oh, wow. That's an interesting way to write this out.
It didn't really work that well because I don't think the fonts are monospace. So.
Okay.
LB is platform, X is shield, and move is D-pad.
So okay. We got a programmer here, we've got an artist, and we've got a level designer. Hey, look at that, Ryan.
Cool.
Somebody dedicated to doing design work.
Wow.
Like actual, like, let's figure out how these like pieces go
to content.
Wow. Imagine we could do. We didn't have to both do that together.
Yeah.
All right. Let's get this going.
So
we're expecting great things from your level designer. Oh God. Okay. Hope this works.
This may or may not full screen properly because Game Maker is weird sometimes.
Guess what? We're not able to do make
try
it that much bigger.
You try it.
Guess what? We're gonna also do.
Capture the window.
Yep. We're gonna go in here. Application. Star Buddy.
Is Duality still open? Or is it just showing in that list?
Uh-oh. Hang on. We're going to do one more here. Hang on. Star Buddy. Click. And turn that off.
We could just do the Alt-Enter thing just to see if it works, but...
All right, fine. We'll just get rid of this. Live demo, folks.
Sometimes when we full screen certain games, they just don't work.
Yeah, sometimes they
just
explode.
Capture black screen. So we'll all try right. It. See what happens.
All right, Star Buddy. What is it? Alt Enter?
Yeah, probably. Oh.
Already this is going good. Already.
Oh, okay.
Well, I've started the game.
So the game's on, so we're going to wait a second to see if it actually captures. I don't know.
I'm gonna go ahead and hit Alt function F12 or F11 just because I assume it's not going to work.
Okay.
Just because most of the Game Maker games, we've touched, or I touched also before we started this. They just freaked out as soon as you... I bet it's going to go white. In fact, that...
Oh, it's black.
Uh-huh, it's black. That's better. It's better than...
No, the chat's saying it's just a black screen, so...
Okay, so I've I've pressed a key. It should... Should do something. It's, should update.
It's Game Maker.
Hey, there you go.
Wow. That's,
yeah, but
that's weird.
Yeah.
Let's just capture the window, I guess, because that's kind of...
That's annoying.
Kind of bad.
Well, good luck figuring out how to get out of this.
We made our game in Game Maker, and we had issues capturing screenshots in full screen for some reason. It was just capturing black.
Yeah. So what can I do here? Should I do...
Can you just capture the window?
Yeah, let's do window capture, and we'll turn off that game capture. This window four star, but wait, that's gonna be the wrong
that'll be the
thing.
Folder probably, right?
Yeah, let's no, that would probably be the web page.
No, that'd be the folder. Oh, you didn't
so
have
we'll launch. We'll launch Star Buddy. We'll go back to OBS, and then we'll see Star Buddy right there.
That's the web page.
Oh, that's the web page.
You might have to kill this window and open it again, or hit refresh.
You're probably white. Right. what? Yeah, thanks, OBS.
That's what you get for using open source software.
That
it's probably made with Game Maker Studio.
That is probably correct. let's do entire window.
Yeah, inner window.
Inner window.
Let's try that.
And we're gonna go click. And we're gonna turn off that. And we're gonna turn off that.
And is it just doing the same thing?
Sort of. We're gonna just go here and edit one thing. We're gonna drag this bigger because it is capturing it.
Just make it as big as we can.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be perfect.
No, I have a button I can click right here. Oh, fit the screen. It? Yeah.
Perfect. All right. Okay, all right. We should be good now.
And then we're gonna not edit the scene anymore. And then we're gonna
go back. To
click
game.
Here.
All right.
There
press
we go.
Key to start.
Press key to start. Right. Press key to start.
It doesn't work with a controller, so.
All right. Here you go. Okay, A and D is movement, but I bet that is your bumpers.
This is very hard to read. Left bumper, right bumper is attack, jump, defend. Okay.
You got it?
Yeah, you have to click through again, I think.
Okay.
We're good.
Okay, cool. I was just looking over the preview monitor. Oh. It's very delayed, and it still had OBS over top of it, so I'll move this mouse cursor off.
Okay.
That's interesting.
So I got a bunch of moves, so I can attack.
Hey, Rayman.
Okay.
Can you jump on any of that stuff there?
I don't want to risk it.
Okay.
Oh, you mean the mushrooms?
Yeah. How are you aiming that? Is it just...
It auto-targets.
Oh, it auto-targets. Yeah. What's that bar at the top?
I don't know. Oh,
that's your health.
There we go. We found out.
Don't abuse Buddy. He's all you've got.
So I have a shield I could use when that's going to happen, I guess.
Oh, really?
Let's go like this.
Try it.
I'll just punch it.
That's some serious Foley work there.
Sounds like slapping a sausage. Or a ham.
Or a hand, perhaps.
Or a hand. Oh, come on. Lock on. All right.
Is that using up Buddy's or your health when you swing
it? Oh, thanks.
It almost looks like it's going up.
I don't know.
Mm. All right, you should...
I was supposed to... There's something up here. What's that
thing? Yeah, use him to platform up. What is... Oh, God.
I don't think I'm supposed to do this. Oh, jeez. These guys just follow me forever. All right, later. So am I supposed to... I'm supposed to find ship parts?
Oh, yes. Yeah, you're supposed to be looking for ship parts, and God only knows you've missed three of them already.
Maybe. Okay.
Here, you want to throw me the laptop? I'll keep an eye on the chat there in case somebody's saying you're screwed already.
I gotta try to survive here, though.
Okay.
I think I turned into a skeleton.
You got a brief moment of reprieve.
Alright.
Oops. There we go.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Hello, chat.
So, yeah, the controls are a little floaty. Wait, what's this?
Ship part found. Hooray! You found the washing machine.
All right, so I'm going to say that level might have been a little bit too long for what it was.
Yeah. Well, I wonder how many parts you got to find. I also wonder what that thing up there that might be
like
shooting.
A moon. Oh, jeez.
That's jellyfish.
Okay, it's a shooting jellyfish.
It's just like Soma. We're not in space at all. We're at the bottom of the ocean.
Spoilers.
Oh, shut up. Grow up. Somebody in the chat here says, was the space setting an excuse to make it floatier?
Maybe. I don't have a lot of control over this.
Can you,
platform.
Like, point the joystick, like, and then send him to platform mode?
No, it looks like it just kind of sticks underneath of me. So it's almost like double jump.
Yeah. So I jump. Okay, well, why don't you jump as far as you can, and then
deploy. But he sinks immediately, so I have to go quick.
Well, then go quick.
Oh, geez. It's really floaty. There's no such thing as quick in this game. Oh, my.
Yeah, okay. We did it.
That was a tight jump. Oh, no. Oh, I'm totally going to die. All right.
Well, we'll find out what death looks like in this game. Yeah, take that, you idiot. That. Take that, you sleeping indigenous life form. Life form, I should say.
Oh.
You're dead. You kind of look horrifying.
You look like a skeleton. I think I'm good.
You're dead already. Can I give it a shot real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
Here, and I'll trade you a controller for... screw you, it's my computer. All of these are my computers. Deadbeat, you didn't bring any of your laptops. All right, I'm in control here. What was the movement? Oh, it's that guy. Okay.
Yeah, we're gonna try to get to your games. Again, if you're here, let me know so we can prioritize yours, because we have a couple in the chat that they want us to play their games.
Hmm.
So we gotta get through. So that you can just push your way through, sort of.
Yep.
But they keep following. They don't give up. They're not like Dark Souls enemies where they just kind of snap back.
That's all right. I like them where they are now.
Just hidden, stuck.
All right, let's see how hard this actually is.
Yeah, take that.
Oh boy.
It's not trivial.
Hang on. I bet I can do this. This is a game for babies, Ryan. This is easy. There we go. See? I'm exactly where you were.
Trivial.
Take that, you sleeping idiot. There we go.
Whoa. Okay, that guy's gonna jump on top of you here.
No, he won't. See, I like to beat games, Ryan, not give up.
I'm just a scrub.
Oh, Jesus. What am I doing? There we go.
Okay, this one's going to be like a triple jump. Oh, let's see. Then you're stuck.
Nope.
Jump to the left? No, they... Oh, what are you doing?
I'm going to try again.
Jump from the top?
Yeah. Because I think... Yeah, that's what I got to do.
There you go.
Yeah. And I'm just going to jump
totally gonna
to
die
the...
from this, like, octopus. Going to just cheat... Fly across the whole level. That's probably why they put those shooters up there.
Ah, you dickholes.
That's totally why they put those guys up there. You're dead.
No!
Wow, you're pretty high. All right.
Well, there we go. I think we'll call it there.
Cool.
Yeah, it's not bad. Let's put that back up there. Well, we'll keep adjusting monitor capture as we go, I guess.
Yeah.
And all right, minimize this guy here. Okay, cool.
Let's do this. Fire through the next few games.
Level design. So we actually, I could see that there was some level design going on there.
I think they were a little long, a little kind of repetitive.
Yeah.
But.
So let's get down to it. Innovation. I kind of like the, I would be okay giving them a 4 in terms of like, oh, here's a platformer, but you have like this ability to throw and deploy powers essentially to circumvent certain aspects. Like you can throw out platforms in front of you forever.
Yeah,
I'm not quite sure what the comment like "don't abuse buddy" meant. Like if you could only use him
enough,
he might
be able to take hits. Maybe.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Or it's just a very polite way to say please don't cheat.
Yeah, could be that too.
Are you comfortable saying that? I get that. Like only really one of those components is like here. How do I? There we go. We'll take it away. I get that only one of those powers really is for. Circumventing platforming. The others are just kind of like, oh, here's a thing to kill enemies and here's a thing to avoid dying from enemies. But what do you think?
No, I totally agree. It was at least somewhat innovative.
Okay. Doing something different.
Yeah. I don't necessarily think it was fun though.
Is the only way to get 2 and 1 on innovation just to copy like, something
to,
we
to
did before?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Don't copy our games. They're the best. They're totally unique.
Yeah. Fun? Hey, you know what? Oh god, there's something in my eye. Ow. Oh gosh, that hurt. I like platformers.
I would put it lower. I thought
say 3.
I thought the controls were kind of loose. I didn't feel like I had a lot of control over buddy.
I'm okay with that. I did like the idea. So I think if it just was tightened up a little bit, like somebody made the joke, like, oh, it's floaty and stuff, like because of its space setting, and was it a chicken and the egg or an egg kind of thing, which came first. But I could see that being, let's call it, more fun if Buddy's controls and your space astronaut were a little easier to navigate around the space.
Yeah.
Theme. Do we want to just go with another three just because, like,
yeah,
they did a thing?
They did something. It wasn't... Well, I mean, your buddy is shape-shifting into, like, the platform and the punching, and so if you want to... If that was why you liked it so much, I mean, that...
Okay, a gold star. Yeah, an extra gold star. Graphics, I think they're serviceable. Okay, this is just personally. I don't like the look of him.
I think he looks like a skeleton.
Yeah, he looks a little horrifying to me. There is at least like cohesive art direction going on. Like, you know, everything kind of looks like it comes from the same game.
There's like gradients in the background on the characters.
Obviously, a very specific art style for this guy. Like, there's no outlines really on things. So that's you know, always tricky to make work against a lot of different backdrops and colors and stuff. So I didn't love the look of it, but I think it's fine. So.
The audio, I don't know.
Music
for three is fine. Yeah
there's music.
Some
of the sound effects are a little homebrew sounding, and of course, like, everything you made here was homebrew, like you made them for the game jam, but that punching sound, it comes up a lot.
Yes.
And it's not the best sound. I think there could have been some either, you know, an effect on
some
it
processing
or,
on it, yeah.
Or just something that feels stronger.
Or add a few different ones so it cycles through them. Or...
Yeah, that too. Now, maybe there was and we weren't noticing the difference. Oh. And yeah, maybe we'll sound like idiots. Humor, should we just NA these? Because I don't...
It obviously wasn't meant to be funny, or I don't know if it's meant to be moody, but I don't like that rating. I can give it a three.
Three?
Yeah.
More threes than fours?
Yeah. That's how I do it.
All right, I'm gonna write great idea.
There you go.
Great idea. I know we're saying great idea to a lot of people, but it's like the value, I think, is coming out of like us just sort of trying to discuss it here in the moment. I don't know. Are one of the developers in the chat have any questions?
I don't know if this developer is. I'm not entirely sure.
But I liked it. I think I'll like everything we see today, but, you know. Yeah.
Yeah, I think we're good.
All right, let's move on. Onward and upward.
All right.
Toyquake. Let's click some screenshots here. Oh, that's a long screenshot. That's a bigger screenshot. Toyquake by Pickens Incorporated. Please leave a comment.
I think I've seen this one.
When voting for the audio, please disregard the music since it is royalty-free track from...
Yeah, I guess doesn't that technically mean the rules say we can't vote in the audio?
Because
they have to use all
Ludum Dare, nailing it with their friggin' rules and rating system.
That rule.
Oh my god. Let's get to this. Get back and forth as much as... Wait, sorry. Here we go. This is where it starts. The heathen trickster wizard is at it again. Returning from LD31, Ludum Dare 31, yep, to cause more mischief, he has trapped you while dungeoneering in one of his little games. Get back and forth as much as possible, all while he rearranges the levels in between, and get as much treasure as possible before you die, Ryan.
This one's pretty simple. I've seen this one.
Arrow keys to move, press up again to double jump.
Yep, you're just running back and forth, dodging, basically. It's pretty
all right, so it's like that game where the trash is falling on you. What is it called? The incident or something?
Yes.
Smug jerk.
Oh, jeez.
Crud. All right, this is already going. OBS.
You want to window capture it?
Yeah, we're going to window capture
it. That seems to be the easiest thing to do.
I do not trust.
So, yeah.
Hey, you know what?
Oh, you don't even have to switch the source?
There we go. We just turned the sources off. That works. Okay, so now... Oh, good lord. I accidentally clicked out.
So
it's arrow keys?
Yes. And
okay.
Then up is jump, I assume?
Yeah. All right, so let's... Let's give this a shot.
So you want to jump across, I think, and get the treasure on the other side, and you can double jump. Oh, you just made a mud. You clicked outside the window.
God dang it. Well, this is gonna be hard. Here, I'm gonna just put this down here.
We have a very small table to work with here.
Yeah.
It's covered in microphones.
It is. All right, here we go.
Okay, you get double jump. There you go.
Okay.
So he, when he hits the platforms, they shrink.
Oh.
That was a good move.
Thanks, Ryan.
That was good. It's a Ryan move.
Oh, I just need to hit enter to, okay.
Oh, to start over?
Yeah.
Whoa. Oh, this should be easy. Just go for it.
If I touch him, is that bad?
I don't know.
If I touch his things, is that bad?
Assume yes. Whoa. This is kind of... Aw.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
This is kind of cool.
A heathen trickster.
I mean, it's super simple, but...
Ryan, do you want to push up that third fader just a little
this
bit?
This one?
Just a little bit.
Like that?
Yeah.
Is that our volume?
No, the third one is the game.
Oh.
I would have labeled these, but...
But you're slacker.
Yeah. It's because I can hear this music, and it's not bad. Oh, but this is... Oh, right. This is the game that just said it was like, oh, this is royalty-free music.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Okay, those bullets don't kill you. The ones he's dropping. But they do shrink the platform, so... It's getting harder?
Yeah, they're shooting more. This isn't so bad.
I like this kind of... It's very simple, but it looks like it's probably pretty fun.
Ah, did you want to give it a whirl?
Nah, I got the gist of it.
All right, I'll try one more. My high score is, what, 6 or 5?
Five, I think.
It's just one of those things. I don't love movement controls on the arrow keys. I know why people do it, but...
I mean, they're the same as WASD, technically.
Eh,
maybe not on this
like
keyboard.
The jumping on the same as the movement keys is always a little weird for
me. Yeah. Yeah, I don't like that.
I like a separate button.
Well, a lot of emulators have it like the Z or X key.
Oh, balls. All right.
All right.
Well, I'm dead.
5. Matt's amazing at this game.
I'm pretty good at video games. All right, let's...
I like that.
Yeah.
Nice, like short and sweet.
Yeah.
It's my favorite kind of game jam game.
All right. Let's scroll back up here. Toyquake. Why is it called
Toyquake? You could have pressed space to jump.
Oh, could I?
Oops.
Let me give it one more whirl. Sorry.
See if you get more than 5. With
yeah,
space.
I bet I can do better. That one there.
All right.
All right.
So space.
I bet I'll do better.
I'm not a big fan of space for jumping either, but
I like space for jumping more.
Yeah. Is it better already?
Yeah. Yeah.
More precise.
Yeah.
There you go.
Give me an easy level. Come on.
It's going to take forever now. Matt's going to get to like 30.
Well, I hold the record in our game mode shift.
He gets very addicted to games like this, I think.
No, I don't.
At least the ones
just
he made.
Just give me a couple more lives. Okay, well, your game's clearly broken. Sorry, I don't know how to rate this now. It's broken.
0.
0 for controls. No, there we go.
No, that's cool.
Yeah. Thank you for sharing that. Okay, let's get through this. Yeah, we gotta
a lot more games.
More games, less time. Innovation. I like
the idea of the platform changing in between and in the single screen games.
Yeah, it's a simple thing, simple space and ping pong and back and forth, kind of cool. I wonder if those are all randomly generated levels.
They totally are. Yeah.
Now, are you able to beat all of them?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
I assume
the maximum height of the first platform is 2 double jumps.
Probably.
Like, executed properly.
Yeah.
Fun. I'm going to say 4, because I like those kinds of games. And,
Yeah, no, that looked awesome. I'd totally play that.
Theme.
I don't know.
Again, one of those things is.
Yeah. Don't worry. The theme stuff's dumb.
Yeah.
Graphics. I liked how it looked.
Yeah.
It nailed what it was going for.
Yeah.
I don't think it was anything like out of this world, but it's very simple.
Yeah,
I think the wizard's hat kind of doesn't really fit.
The particle effect's a little cheating if you're trying to do like pixel perfect stuff.
Yeah.
And
that's not pixel perfect, but
no, but the aesthetic works for what it is.
Yeah,
it's a simple game running back and forth. So I'm comfortable with a 4.
And audio, like,
well, let's not
break the rules, I guess. Or do you want to be crazy? 4.
I liked your song.
Yeah, the music was good.
Good. Champion the thing I always say, you know, I hate the friggin' rules on Ludum Dare so much for, like, how they treat audio. There's much effort needed to make sure you pick the right sound or the right music for a thing.
you need as much skill and ear to pick the right thing to, you know, elicit the right mood or feelings or, you know, make the appropriate choice as it would take to build a piece of music. Like, as long as you credit things correctly or, you know, own it or whatever, like, I feel that
you should be able to.
You should be able to.
Because it's very hard.
As long as you legally can do it, I feel that you should not be, like, kicked out. Like, maybe you, no. I don't know.
No,
it's just, it's silly.
4 stars overall, I guess.
Yeah.
Let's average it out. Awesome game.
Yeah.
Put more than, like, put a paragraph. Don't put caps. It's going to make it look like a game in the system.
Okay, fine. Here, you write it
keyboard
out.
Doesn't work over here.
Well, whatever. Deal with it. Yeah, so that's been a pet peeve of mine for a long time. Like, just that, you know, music selection or, like, sound selection or just, like, what was the word I used for it? It's not, music curation is a, you know, that's a set of skills, like knowing what to use and when and how. And it, you know, it's fine that if a game, a competition where they don't want to, I'm gonna hit submit there, that is interested in creation rather than curation, wants to not vote on the skills for curation, that's fine, I guess, but it's super annoying that they, like, bleh. Anyway.
So what's the next one?
Next game.
Okay, I've played this one already, so.
So we'll make this one quick. I'll just jump through it.
Don't even worry about it. I've rated this one already and gave feedback, so.
Oh.
Let's get through the ones of people that are here, because we have a limited amount
okay,
of time.
Okay, sorry.
This game was all right. It was actually made by a father and his young daughter.
Oh.
So his young daughter came up with the design and drew all the art. And the dad programmed it, which I thought was
Are neat. They in the chat?
I don't know. I don't think they are. They didn't give me any contact information to get a hold of them.
Okay, well, so we'll maybe,
we can come back to this one.
Yeah,
maybe
we'll come back at the end just because we want to get through
I have these. A list of a few here from the chat if we want to get through those.
What was this one called?
Swedish Fish something. Scroll down.
Or is it Dustin Finnemore?
Oh. No, the game's called, like, Swedish something fish. Swedish stretchy fish.
Oh, okay.
Let's do some of these ones from the chat.
Oh, God. How do I get them? Did you put them in?
Just search for them. So go back to the Ludum Dare site. Oh, get ready to download some stuff.
Oh, God. I don't.
Click on Ludum Dare at the top because this site's terrible to navigate. Yeah, click that. And then if you click play and rate games.
Oh, look at that. Oh, no.
Yeah,
we're
here,
on
here. Play mode shift.
Play mode shift.
Mode underscore shift.
Mode underscore shift is a fun game. Little game. I have the record. Hold on. Sorry, Ryan. I want to just do this again.
That's going to show off again. Hold on. I'm going to delete a score. Just give me 1 second.
No, screw off. I will kill you. We're in my house and I have a knife in the kitchen or something probably.
Play mode shift. We spent a lot of time on this title screen and the intro.
How the frig do I... Here, we'll do that. There. I have the high score of 100.92 seconds. Beat that, everyone. It's pretty swell. I hope that was captured. Oh, well. Where am I going, Ryan?
Go up. See where it says play and rate games.
Yes.
In the now on or on now Ludum Dare thing. Scroll it. Oh, yeah. That one
works
too,
probably. I clicked here.
And then search.
Oh, boy.
Search for Douglas. With an apostrophe after the S. Space. Escape.
Oh, boy. Whoops.
You're going to learn about Matt's great spelling and typing
skills. No, I also put a slash.
It probably actually put that in automatically. It's just escaping the character.
And I put an L in there by accident.
Okay.
Is this it?
Yeah. Hmm. Click on that. Let's download it.
Ooh, look at that.
Looks cool. Windows.
I swear to God, if this is a virus, I am going to not be happy.
Be a good way to spread malware.
Please don't. Ryan, shut
up. Don't do it,
buddy. Just shut up, Ryan. You're giving everyone the worst ideas.
Right. Who's game with this? I think this guy, Master RGB Pixels, in the chat. Okay, let's see if this...
Well, this just started. Jonathan Blow would just be ecstatic with you. let's give it a second to catch up with the stream here, because we got to... I'm just trying to get my phone out.
I got to sit back, because...
Your back's hurting?
My back.
Sorry.
My old back.
He
said it's not a virus, don't worry. That sounds like something... Someone would say if they were trying to spread a virus.
Yeah, that does sound like something someone who's trying to spread a virus would say.
But this isn't my computer, so I don't care. This is Matt's computer.
Thanks. I got a feeling this is going to be nice
just a
white screen.
Yeah, so Alt-Enter.
There.
Oh.
Great, another white screen.
Oh. Okay, so just capture the window.
Yep. Oh, excuse me.
And invest in a cough button.
Shut up, Brian.
You might have to pick the window this time.
Yep. I think think we lost our... Oh, no.
That's the... Okay, just pick it. Hit refresh, maybe. They're kind of...
Okay, yeah. I just need to edit this real quick. OBS. Sometimes she's easy to use. Sometimes she's not. What am I doing here? Full screen. There. There.
Perfect.
Perfect.
All right, let's play this. I can cut it here. It might be a little low.
Here, yeah. We can just...
He said the graphics might be buggy when you're not in full screen, so let's see what happens.
Oh, boy. Maybe some dirt is left. Oh, okay, I'm moving.
Wow, you move so fast. Oh, it's like a roguelike. What'd you just do?
I made dirt.
By clicking on existing dirt?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, well, if you could see me right now...
He's got his hands crossed.
Yeah, drink to restore some mana. So... Okay. I like the art.
Uh-oh. Let's walk through him. Nope. Walk back. Oh. Okay. So it's not just walk into him. Like a roguelike.
Spike
is... rise him through the air? Let's fight him.
You can only leap 2 blocks.
So you can jump up that?
Okay.
They take mana. Okay.
That guy...
Oh. Stomp it.
Okay.
So you... Yeah, bring that one up. Oh. I don't think you can do it when you're on it. So you bring up 2.
That's all I can do.
Can you bring it
up? I think I'm out of...
Oh. There you go. Now you can jump that. Now you can jump that.
Oh.
Oh, crap.
Well, we're screwed here.
So you can't bring that up?
Can I, like, remove that?
We didn't read the instructions.
I think I maybe like screwed up because I like lost too much mana at the start.
Can you restart? R.
I hit escape and now it locked up.
You should have hit R. Matt quit the game.
Nope. It maybe no, crashed. Fine. Oh, not Toyquake. Right, that's the wrong game. Hold on.
This is going swimmingly.
Hold on.
You said R restarts.
Okay, good. As soon as I bring it back up, we will do that.
And someone keeps spamming 156 in the chat for some reason.
156 is probably his score in mode shift.
Seconds. Is that your score in mode shift? Because if it is, I'm pretty impressed.
Yeah, well, this isn't much to impress you, Ryan. You just got to be good at video games.
Hey, you only have 100.
All right, so let's try this again.
So you can't do it when you're on it. You have to be off of it. So you click it again. And then you have to go up. You can jump those tiles.
Okay.
Yep, 150 seconds. Or 156 wow. seconds. All right, you're...
Well, screw you. you aren't allowed to play the game anymore because you're better than me.
Matt doesn't like being bested in video games.
No. You're a bad person, whoever you are. No, I'm sure you're great. I'm just...
So get up there quick before this guy gets to you. How do you grow it? You click it, right? Do you click and then click?
Left click. Okay, got it. Okay,
you can't be on. You messed up. You have no mana left anymore. You screwed up.
Well, I don't know how I was going to get enough to even do this, though.
Because that thing eats your mana when it hits you.
All right. Oh, hey, I just
So rush. Quick. Boom, boom.
Fuck.
You messed up again.
Man.
So just stomp it. Maybe. Okay. Restart. So go over. Take your time. Over. Left. Right. Right. Okay. Up. Climb. Up. Climb.
There okay. You go. Oh, boy. Sometimes there are 2. I got a feeling this game's going to be tricky and demand...
You used too much mana there, probably. Use 1. Go up. No, you don't need 2. Okay,
no, I wanted 2.
Okay.
Oh, boy. I'm just rearranging to avoid carpal tunnel again.
Oh, my back is going to be so bad.
Sorry, Ryan. Oh. Living life takes freedom.
What? Did I just restart? Wait.
What?
Takes mana. Oh, is this it? I think we beat it.
Did we beat it?
That was it.
Is the developer saying that?
No, but that was definitely it, because we've already been this level.
Maybe I screwed up. Here, hang on. I know how to beat this game, or at least get back to where I was real fast.
Just don't forget to squish the bug.
Yeah.
You don't have health.
Doesn't matter.
Oh, weird. Okay.
Sometimes there are two.
Okay, so read what the message says. Prepare yourself.
Sometimes
it ends badly.
Living life.
Can you click that up behind him? I don't know. Just go for it. I think we beat it. He said we did beat it. He said it's metaphorically deep. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Well, there we go.
Cool.
All right. Well, let's switch that back. Cool. Well, there we go. We played Douglas's Escape. Oh, right. Freedom Escape. Got it. All right. I was wondering, like, why is it... What is he getting at with the name? Cool. I guess we didn't even read this. Art to restart, escape to quit. Yeah, I guess it didn't crash. I hit escape.
Yep.
Major tip for pro players. Dirt below creates... very right-clickable. Pro gamers. No new features added.
Just change log.
Let's get to this. It's kind of a cool idea. You're shifting around, like sliding around, doing stuff.
Yeah, and I've never seen like a side-scrolling roguelike like that.
Yeah, one that's turn-based.
Like a turn-based one. Yeah, it was interesting.
Yeah. Do we want to go with three?
I give it a four.
Four.
Yeah.
Turn-based. Fun.
You tell me.
So it's a it's a puzzle game.
Yep.
But we didn't get to see a huge exploration of the ideas.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, limited time, limited level creation ability.
And obviously, a lot of time spent on the art here.
Yeah, it looks
like
fantastic.
This is really good. I like a lot of this. So I think we have no problem giving you five cohesive art direction and good execution on it. The only thing I would say, so I'm kind of dancing around the bush here. The game we played earlier, the one with the two shifty dimension things. What was that? Duality or Duet?
Duality, yeah.
Duality. Like that, that's what I call a fun game jam puzzle game. Because they had different priorities, and maybe one of the priorities was like, let's make sure we can explore an idea fully or more.
Yep.
And I like that. I can see where some of the ideas could go in this game. It just doesn't feel like there's a lot of... You don't get to do a lot in the game.
Yeah.
And then a lot of it still feels like a tutorial and is just like...
It just lacks content.
Yeah. It feels like at the end of the game there, we're just about... Like, we're going to actually start the game right now, and then it just starts over. So it's like...
Which means I think this could be kind of expanded upon.
Yeah,
definitely. It could be pretty interesting.
Yeah, there could be a lot of really cool things that you go with this. So I this is what I guess what I'm trying to say is I would say three, like, for what it is right now. For fun, but definitely like if you explore these ideas and flesh them out and made more content with them, that could probably be a really fun swell game.
Yeah, the mechanics are sound.
Yeah.
So
yeah, theme shape shifting. I don't know, three.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna do the old three here.
I like the audio. The sound fit pretty well.
Yeah.
I'd say it was like a three or four, probably a four.
Four? Okay.
Nothing offensive about it. Like, it all went together pretty well. Nothing stood out, which is sometimes a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Humor.
N-A.
Yeah, sure. N-A.
N-A. Cool. Sorry. I don't like rating these dumb ones. I'd say it's a four there. Evens out. Right?
Yeah.
Four.
Yeah, yeah. Totally. Great
That's
game.
That's good.
With a bit more content, a few more levels.
I'm going to write nice idea, not in all capitals.
Graphics look great.
Nice idea. GFXs.
Oh.
Because I'm being elite. Are great. Well. Oh, Jesus.
The keyboard?
Or well just your typing? Done. This is under your account?
Yes. Don't put anything racist
I'm
or
an
terrible.
Idiot and make bad choices. No, I'll get rid of
it. All right, I gotta go.
Okay.
Stream's over.
All right. There we go.
All right.
There we are. All right. There's
cool.
one.
I got another one.
You got another one? Do we want to...
through this.
What are we doing? Are we going back through this
no,
list?
No, I got a few more on the stream right now. People are around, so I want
okay,
to look
okay,
stuff.
Okay, okay, okay.
Theseus.
Oh,
I will spell it.
I got them from here, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
T-H-E-S-E-U-S. Theseus, isn't that a...
There we go. Theseus. I don't know.
Uh-oh.
No, it's the one on the right. That's not the game at all.
Agent Shapeshifter. Oh, God. My legs are cramping up. Ugh.
You should get a standing desk. I got a standing desk.
Well, we should be... Ryan, why are we not standing up doing this?
I should have brought my standing desk. It only weighs like 200 pounds.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I should
probably... This is the wrong game.
Is it?
Yes, I've said that twice already.
You told me this is the right one.
No, the one on the right is what I meant. On the one on the right.
Okay, I think I just ignored what you said because this one said Agent Shapeshifter.
You're probably drawn to the title. This is the one by the Mjork. Mjork. He's in the chat, I think.
Hey, Webb, let's do that. That's faster than downloading. And it probably...
Want to just do that? Like,
oh, boy.
If you can get rid of that stupid smooth scrolling on your mouse. That's probably good.
Close enough. You know what? Let's just...
just download it.
Because, of course, I'm going to need to see the top bar there and...
Something's going to pop up.
Something's going to be... Oh, what the...
Dropbox wants you to sign up.
No. Download. No. Save. Okay, hang on a second here.
Yeah, I see you use WinRAR.
I do.
Did you buy a license?
I'm just gonna blank the screen while we... yes, use WinRAR and my paid copy of it.
Do you think anyone's ever bought WinRAR?
One person has, and he obviously gave them $1 million because this product is still supported. By the way, did I tell you I gave them $1 million once?
Wow, I didn't know you were rich.
I'm very rich.
You should buy a better mouse and keyboard.
Listen, you can...
And a bigger TV.
Shut...
Matt's TV, we're looking at it right now, it's like 22 inches.
You can shut up. All right, and window capture. There we go. That doesn't look like the right size.
Oh, it's being stretched. That's weird. Yeah, it's cutting off the bottom. What?
Yeah.
Try refreshing it. I might still be using the old aspect ratio.
Let's just do that. And then back here, Game Maker Studio. And we're just going to try
position. Fit. Okay, there we go.
Good.
So we do read the page for this one?
Yeah, let's read the page of this nice piano jam.
Puzzle underneath. Platformer, you can't jump, but you can't grow, you can change, and you can leave something behind. 20 levels, so we're not going to play all those. Left to right, A, D to move, press spacebar or right mouse to prepare a split, press shift to fuse.
Ryan, why don't you play this one?
Okay.
I'm going to move.
Okay. Matt's going to watch the chat.
Oh, my back.
All right.
As soon as I heard puzzle game, I thought, well, you know who's clever? Ryan.
That's right. Ryan the programmer.
Yeah. I just draw the pictures and make the sounds.
All right. What am I doing?
Well, you're going to go back over to the Game Maker application.
And D to move, spacebar to prepare, and shift to fuse.
All right. Oh, my God. This is going to be a messy looking video just because, like, when we flipped back over there, we didn't have desktop capture enabled, so it's just like a cropped view of the desktop.
Oh, really? Oh, well, it happens.
Oh, God.
Little feet.
Now, move that mouse off the screen. Unless you're going to need the mouse.
I'm going to put it right there.
Wow. Okay. He doesn't like it either. Idiot.
Okay.
Just going to bring this down just a smidge.
Move mouse near yourself to highlight a square. Click to grow there. That's why I need the mouse. Okay. Crap.
1 second. I just dropped
my coasters.
All right, let's
do this. You knocked them on the ground.
Move those near yourself. Circle. Okay. Cool.
So you cannot fall by doing that. Okay.
Yeah, and I need as many squares as there are dots. I have to cover them all at once, so I can go boom. I can survive this.
Hey, I have to go. Wait. Do not grow. More than two units.
How many
big
do I have? I have two. Okay, so I need two up?
You gotta go two up, but you're not gonna be able to finish the game if you do two up. Unless you can rotate. Up.
Unless, like, oh, wait, I can. Can I? Okay, I can't move them. Because now I don't have enough. Yes, I do. I have enough.
Well, no, you just can't fit.
Oh, I'm too tall, yeah. Oh, crap. Wait. Boom.
Oh, what? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. See it up in the.
Cool. Okay.
Wait, to exit, don't stand on blocks without exit pads.
Oh, what?
Have you screwed up?
Yeah, because I'm not. I need to be like straight up in the air.
Oh, can you click on your parts already to like remove them?
No. So is this impossible for me to beat now? Or am I missing something? Oh, wait, I can do this. Watch this.
Oh, I see. Got it.
This is cool.
Clever. Now, the problem here...
Okay. I'm dumb, so...
Yeah, do that. Yeah, you're stupid as hell.
Oh, crap.
Start that one over. I wonder if this is designed in such a way that, like, you will always, like... Like, could you be screwed already? Because, like, you built your shape this way?
I'm going to say no. There's got to be one solution.
Yeah.
Otherwise, that would be kind of insane.
Yeah. Okay, we'll try this again. But, fall down. So...
So I don't want to fall down. So I put one here.
Yeah. Ah, damn it.
I did it. Wait.
Yep. Uh-huh. Okay, hang on. Okay. Grab that one. So, go down.
Almost more like this. No, that'll... It's...
Yeah, go... No,
that was
go.
Fine. That was fine. Okay.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
One more.
You put it...
Here.
Then sure.
One more. Here.
Okay,
one
but
more.
We're not going to have enough to solve the game now.
Yeah, we will.
No, because you got to get... You have to be, like, three and then four. See? You screwed up, you idiot.
Wait.
No. Not quite.
Crap.
That would work, but we've spent one too many.
I used one too many. Okay, so I think I was on the right track. So here, where do we do it?
I think the developer's in the chat. He says you can't get stuck in this version. There are a few alternate solutions. If you get those, your shape will just change between levels to make sure you don't get stuck.
Oh, that's one
okay.
way to do it.
Yeah, no, that's kind of what I was thinking would happen. You just, nope, sorry, you're going to be... Okay, what if you... How do you have your one? Yeah,
do that, I'm screwed.
Yeah.
I fall down. Like, the only solution here that I can tell is to go like this. But now I can switch it up. And I'm going to fall off the edge right when I do this.
Wait.
What did I do last time? Am I dumb?
Yeah, but that doesn't matter. Wait, why don't you just stick... Yeah, it there... Can
nah,
you?
That's not going to do anything.
Yeah, but can you, like, sneak past? Like, can
you, no, because you snap to...
Oh, you just snap. Oh, sorry. That was analog.
You basically snap, yeah. Here's where I put it, I thought. Am I dumb? Oh my god. Alright, we're gonna have to call this quits soon.
Okay, I do want to solve this one though.
Oh, how did I do it last? I don't know how I did it last time anymore.
Well, you just kept jamming things on the one piece that you...
Oh, I did it when I was...
Yeah, you did that one there.
Falling?
No. You just moved over. Move over.
Yeah.
And then you stuck
it
there.
I thought I put it here, but then I can't get further.
Yes, you can. Click it and go...
Oh, I'm gonna fall right when I move this piece.
Oh.
See? I'm pretty sure it's what I did, but...
Okay, no. Start over. Yeah, good luck. Start over. Get that one. Go fall. Now put it underneath where the... yes.
That's not going to work either.
Shouldn't it?
No, because watch. I'm going to fall in the hole now.
Oh.
what did I do last time? Am I just dumb? I'm probably just dumb.
Hmm.
Oh, it was this one.
Yeah. Ugh. We're stupid.
Okay, so I need to save one, I guess. So
we'll put one there.
Put this here. Okay.
Yeah.
That's okay. What I want to do. So I...
Okay.
I won't fall.
We're not going to fall.
I won't fall.
Okay.
Okay, this is it. Okay.
So
I need one...
Move over one more. Here. Okay, yeah, yeah. There we go.
Cool.
Okay, this looks easy. Let's figure this one out.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure it's easy. How the heck...
Huh.
So I need to catch it almost.
Can you build them while you're falling?
I'm not gonna be able to.
Well, fall and see if you can move.
Oh wait, I just moved.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I thought
that's
was
not so hard. This one's easy. I can already see how to do it. Maybe. Yep. Easy.
Trivial.
Easy. This. Press the spacebar or right click.
Right click to
produce. Oh right, there was a whole splitting mechanic.
Move mouse to choose split location.
do? Well, good job, Ryan. You just sliced it wrong. Well, there we go.
Cool.
Let's say that's a wrap on what was this one called? Theseus?
Theseus.
Right, Theseus.
Switch back over.
Oh, jeez. All right.
That's my spot.
Oh my god. I'm all tangled up. Ugh. Oh, cramps. Oh, okay. Theseus. I guess I'm in control again.
Yep.
Where are we? Here we go. All right. Well, that was great. I like that. I'm going to say at least a 4 on innovation.
Yeah, it was definitely unique.
That's a fun little exploration of puzzles and shapes and spaces. Putting pegs in holes and wrapping things around it. Tricky. Tricky puzzle. And again, one of those things where, like, and it's obviously always a time constraint, but it looks like they got to explore their idea.
Yeah.
And do some things with it. And that ultimately, I think, always influences the fun directly with these kinds of games. Like we saw with the last one, the escape game. Like, they didn't really have a lot of time to explore the ideas. They got them across, but I bet that game would be pretty fun if they got to explore those ideas. And I think this one got to got to explore it. And that's what ends up being the fun thing. It's like, oh, we're solving the puzzles. We're not just being told how to do them. I guess
let's give it a 5. I mean, they did something interesting with the idea of changing shape too.
So. Yeah. Graphics.
I liked it simple, but
yeah, simple.
Definitely nailed what they were going for.
Yeah.
I liked the whole like the pieces of the monster kind of change color. You can see they kind of go from dark to light.
Yeah. Let's scroll back down here. Audio. I would probably go down the middle on this one. Like you have your nice little piano there. But it almost, I don't know if this is supposed to be a very somber game or not, but I don't know. Yeah. Oh, you know, let's just go with a 4. They made this music, right?
I assume. If it's there, we have to assume they made it.
Yeah, they made it. Assume they follow the rules. I like the growth sound and the slicing sound. So, mood, NA.
Whatever. And 4. Yeah, good game.
Good game.
Whoever did that, I can't remember.
Great game.
We'll scroll up and check. This game was Theseus.
Fun. Yep, that is an exclamation point.
I'm always interested in puzzle game design because it's very hard. Like I really appreciate people who can do puzzle design well.
Theseus. Eus.
Yeah. So yeah. What?
There.
Oh, okay.
The Monarch.
Yep. So Theseus by the Meork. Mork.
Or Meork. Yeah, sorry. I said Monarch. Well, good job.
Yeah.
I like that.
Nice.
It's neat.
I got another one here.
All right. Should we... So we're almost at 10, and we sort of set out to do 10. Should we try and wrap in... that number there?
15 minutes?
15 minutes?
Yeah, we can go for the 15 more minutes.
All right.
All right. I got one more here.
All right. What do we got, Ryan?
SPELLDOWN.
Why am I doing this?
Don't search Google. It probably won't come up.
Also, I need to have turned the screen on.
Okay. That's what you use standby for. It's supposed to use standby.
Oh, God. I hate this sometimes. Everyone's probably saying black screen, huh?
Yep. So screen's back or all black, right. You fools.
Thanks, team.
We noticed. Thank you.
Okay. What am I looking up?
SPELLDOWN. All capitals. Not that it should matter. One word. And spelled correctly.
Thank you.
With an exclamation point at the end.
Doesn't matter.
That's the one right there.
Got it.
I think this guy was in the chat. He used to be anyway.
Web, Flash, Air, Zip. Oh, boy.
You don't have Flash Player. All right. Let's just do that. Just run the Swift. It should run on Air. Did you Air? You have that, right?
I have no idea. Isn't that just Adobe Flash? In a
No, it's like, yeah. It's executable Flash.
You should have it. Getting ready.
All right, we have to install Air.
Don't make your games in Flash, folks.
Yep.
Oh, well. Here we go. I'm going to...
Just mess with OBS.
Yeah, let's...
Just capture that Adobe Air window.
Yeah, why not?
So that's our next game, Adobe Air.
Install.
Yep. Oh, unknown publisher. Sure. Oh.
What does that say?
If you can, try to avoid making your games have to be installed. I mean, we're going to install this, but... I'm sure it probably
I agree turns a lot to of install away. Viruses. Go ahead. Go right ahead. All my files are all in here. What was that? Oh, that's something Ben installed.
All right, we're good. Finish. Play. It's in your start menu now.
Great. There it is.
At least it has an icon. Pixel Whoop. Potions.
Whoop. And we're going to go here.
You might be able to full screen this guy.
Yeah, you know what?
Try to make it a little bigger than that anyway.
Let's try and full screen it.
Nope. All right, hit that button. All right, good enough.
Good enough.
I mean, they might have a full screen button in their instructions. Did that just totally break it?
Oh, I don't think there's a tutorial. Is there... use the mouse to draw magical glyphs to beat your opponent, become the magical champion, bugs crashing... Okay, I'm not... Nothing saying that the tutorial shouldn't work.
Alright, let's capture the window. Are you capturing the window?
No, I'm just... I'm doing a big full screen like this. Well, let's do that, because it's easy.
Alright.
Is there audio?
It doesn't seem like it. If the developers here, is there supposed to be audio? Because we're not getting any.
Oh, this is weird.
So what are you doing? Just drawing shapes?
Yeah.
And it fills your vial?
Mm-hmm.
This reminds me of like a Mario Party game. Like that one where you're on the jackhammers.
Mario Party's the worst.
No, it's the best. No, I should try to beat it. We'll see what happens.
Well, I'm just seeing if I can game it.
Oh, it probably gives you a percentage of how much is in the line. The computer's slow.
Got him.
Win. It
turns into a Binding of Isaac enemy.
Okay. Is that pretty much it? Just fill it in. That did not work. Okay, so they've got something going on here.
Something detecting what I'm doing.
We actually let a 5-year-old take over. And that's why the drawing is so bad.
I'm just trying to figure out where the spots might be. Oh, I'm a cat now.
Okay.
Lose!
I like the art.
Yeah, I like the art
too. It's pretty good.
What is it? So I guess this would just probably be the different shapes.
Yeah. So you just draw the same shape over and over again. I think this would be more interesting if
the mixed
up the shapes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because at this point, it's very repetitive.
Obviously, someone's got the easier shape. Like, I bet there's one that seems easier to do.
Yeah, some kind of square one would be easier to do with a mouse.
Or a circle.
Yeah. Go, Matt. Spell down that guy.
I'm going to spell down your doom. Come on. Let's do this. Come on. I bet there's just points inside.
Well, they probably say, okay, you hit this many points inside, and you didn't get this percentage of line outside.
Yeah. Oh, come on. I'm going to... Oh, okay. That looks hard for him. Let's see if I can... Okay.
Man, this guy's way better than you.
Look, I...
Look how close he is to the line. It's almost like he's cheating.
It's almost as if he's a computer. And he's just programmed to fail.
This may also work better in like a multiplayer game instead of a...
I think this would make a great iOS game.
Yeah.
Just because the mouse sucks to
do
stuff like this.
Yeah.
But no, that's cool. It's too bad there's no sound.
Yeah, sound would be great. The art is fantastic.
Yeah, art's great. I think we'll have to call that one there. I think... I'd say it's 3 for innovation. I've seen a lot of things.
Yeah,
like,
I've seen
like
stuff
this.
Like that.
And there's a very fun iOS game, Spell Tower or something. I can't remember what it's. Magic Touch, I think.
Yeah.
That kind of takes these ideas and runs with it. But like the enemies, you have to kill them by doing the gestures or the drawing line stuff, and they're falling from the ceiling, and you can't let them touch the ground.
Okay. And even if there's like different shapes or different spells.
Yeah. So you're not just doing the same one over and over again to try and beat a guy.
It'd be a cool feature built on top of like a JRPG style game.
Let's say that, you know.
Did you have fun with it?
Did
you have fun with it in its current state, or do you think it could be fun?
I think it could be fun.
Okay, yeah.
I'll say in its current state, it's a 3 out of 5. It's a little boring just repeating the thing over and over again.
Yeah.
I think it was Jonathan Blow that said that, like, you know, salient thing about like if all you do in your game is like open locked doors, then your game is about opening locked doors no matter what you write around it.
Yeah.
And in this game it's drawing triangles.
Yeah.
And you're literally just drawing the same shape over and over again. So I think with that earlier criticism, like if you change it up, like you're doing different symbols, and then it's like, oh, I gotta do a circle, and then I gotta
It would be a lot more hectic too, because you're like, oh, I got used to drawing the square. Oh,
yeah,
no, it's the triangle.
That would be fun. In its current state, I think 3 out of 5, but definitely could see this being like, I like that Magic Touch game or whatever. I could see this turning to something similar to that. Themes, literally, you're not changing shapes.
I actually don't. I think this might be our first below 3 because I don't really think.
I mean,
you pick a different character. I'd say below 3.
Ryan's hands on the mouse now, and he clicked too.
It's not, but I agree with you.
Graphics. Hey, I think you made
a
brilliant looking game.
It's one of the best looking games yet that we've seen.
I think.
Art style wise. Humor, I don't know if it's...
Avoid those two?
Yep.
Okay.
As always.
So does this come out as a 3?
Yeah. I think the graphics kind of bring it up.
It's too bad there's no sound.
I know. I think this would be great with sound.
I think this
would
be a great thing to have some fun sound.
Look at that level.
Yeah.
That looks cool.
Great art. Really, really just great art.
Nailed the art.
Yeah. And I think there's more to explore with the mechanics and the way you interact with this game, and maybe even like the platform. Like, maybe it's not supposed to be a computer game. Maybe it is meant to be a touch phone game or something. Yeah, like,
it sure seems like it.
And especially like if you could do multiplayer against another person, like that you know what? That actually would be a neat idea. Like, two people, like, they got their phones, they connect like through whatever phone,
Bluetooth
or whatever it is, like Game Center, and they're getting, it's almost like Space Team. They're being fed
random shapes,
and it's like, oh, I gotta draw my shape, and oh, and you gotta like 12 before the other person does, and then they zap you.
Yeah, and I mean, even if they weren't set shapes, like they were randomly generated weird patterns that you had to follow or something.
And then, like, you know, just wanted to, not to linger on this too much longer, but like it'd be one of those fun things of like, you know, where the medium and the mechanics, like the physical mechanics of it, are like not dissimilar from what's going on in the game. Like, the wizards are like writing their spells from their tome, and they're doing their gestures and casting and preparing to cast their spell. And it's like you're doing that physically with your hand on phone.
You fill out the shape and then you like swipe it to fire it at your...
Yeah, like if you have a big iPad too, it's your big spell book. And like that.
That'd be pretty cool.
There is something there. So, hey, you know what? I know it says 3 out of 5, but you know what? This idea has potential.
I think the idea is fun.
Yeah. Good job. I'm going to write
great idea.
I'm going to say great idea, great game.
Would
love to see it on a phone.
Yeah.
Would love to
see it expanded upon on a phone or something.
Expanded. Oh my God, I can barely expanded.
You can do it. That's, yeah, you got an extra A at the beginning.
Yeah.
There you go.
Expanded upon into a phone game. Game with friends.
Yep.
And a smiley face.
And as Matt's typing, if you're in the chat and you have a game that we haven't looked at yet, or you submitted a game and we haven't looked at it yet, send it, because we're running out of time.
You got between here and here.
We've got about 10-ish
minutes.
Oh, God,
you got like 3 more seconds. Oh, God, 2, 1, and we're done.
No. All right, we got like 10 minutes, so.
We got 10 minutes. So let's close that. Do we have anyone with the current things there, or do we need to go back to this list?
No, we got another one here called Star. There might be a lot of entries with that name. All right, let's do this quick. Let's fire through these, like 2 minutes each. Satar. That's a different thing.
That is not how you spell Satar, Ryan. Satar has a Y in it.
Close enough. Oh, jeez.
All right, we're going to need something else to search by.
It's by Mad SJ. Type that in. One word.
Found it. Windows. Oh. Good.
Wait, stand by. Fine.
There we go.
Let them watch you download.
Sorry, I obviously clicked 0 or something. Oh, yeah, when I hit the... God, OBS, I gotta...
You almost need someone monitoring just...
Well, so here's the way... Last time I did a live show with this, this was a broadcast machine exclusively, so this, like, keyboard was, like, the, like, let's call it TriCaster switcher. So nobody was typing on it. Anything else that had to be typed was with a different computer being fed into this broadcast machine. So, like, this was not a problem. We weren't typing with the machine that was doing all the transitions. This starts right away.
All right.
We're going to... Maybe we'll give it a second
let's see if it's in full screen right now, so it may or may not work.
I like the sound of this already.
Yeah.
Well, something
Are we going to play our game at the end of the stream to finish it off?
Yeah, sure. We'll each have a crack at it or something. All right. Okay. Jamming.
I really wish Twitch was a little faster. I don't know why the delay is so serious.
Okay. All
right, just one second. So window capture.
Yeah, I'm just gonna try. I just clicked one thing. We're gonna give it a second here.
I mean, can't you just look at OBS and I'd have to
flip out and then it comes out. Okay, we're still white. Never mind. All right, we're bouncing out. What is it called? What do they call it when they like jack out of the Matrix? What is that?
what they just call jacking out. No, they call jacking.
Jacking in.
I don't know if they have a pulling out.
They're pulling them out.
Gross.
You have to open. Okay, I gotta run the game. Damn it! Where'd it go?
What just happened?
It's launching.
Oh, really?
I think.
I don't think it is.
Damn.
I could just quit.
There. Okay, and then I'll tab back out. Okay, tab out. And
Do you have like three versions of it open?
I have no idea.
Okay, so switch to that.
This one?
Yes.
I think.
Try outer window. It's a Game Maker game, isn't it? I don't think it's... Well, it might be. Find out.
All right, find out.
Again, this is... Game Maker games seem to be the most finicky when it comes to full screen streaming and capture. I'm not really sure why.
I'm just watching myself there, like, struggle to figure this out. I'm going to bring this down just a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little loud in your ears. All right.
All right, Matthew's catching up with reality here. Oh,
okay, it's black.
Oh, it's not bad. Come on. Is there a command to, like...
He said you can Alt-Enter.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I just did it now, so...
All Game Maker games, I think, support Alt-Enter, so let's just do that.
Okay, we'll do that.
Capture the window, and... Let's just play everything in window mode. Seems to be less finicky.
Let's just do it,
Just bring it up a little bit.
Where's my mouse?
They probably have the mouse disabled. Oh, jeez.
This is a nightmare!
All right, there.
Okay,
we're going to leave it like that.
We're going to do this.
All right, let's play it.
Ryan, where are the controls? You're going to have to help me.
I don't know.
You have a laptop in front of you.
I have a laptop.
I bet I'm just avoiding things.
Arrow keys for movement. Z equals triangle. X equals square. C equals circle. V equals star.
Oh, okay. So I'm trying to like...
Survive and beat the end boss is what it says. Becoming a star requires 10 star points. You get star points by touching the same shape as yourself.
Okay.
You get one life by becoming a star. So I assume you just survive.
Isn't that a metaphor for like the modern like fandom around celebrity? You get one life being a star and then you die. Birth, celebrity, then death.
Yeah, we played Spelldown, Sparrow. The recording of this should be archived on this channel, and it'll also be archived on YouTube at the Hopped Up Gaming East YouTube channel.
Correct, Amungo.
So if you search that, you should see it. I don't know when Matt plans to put it up. I assume soon.
This week. Got some things going on, but I should be able to get to it pretty quick.
Yeah, it should be up sometime this week.
Yeah. You can find Hopped Up Gaming East by just going into YouTube and typing that into the search bar, and it'll be there. And it's also a weekly podcast you can listen to about beer, video games, and all sorts of other fun things. Ryan's the number one fan of the show, and I'm on the show.
Number one fan, but I've never listened to it. No, I've listened to it once.
You've listened to it a couple times. Yeah, you've also sent questions in, but you're like a deadbeat question sender.
I don't ask questions anymore because I ran out.
Well, it's fun, actually. Lately, we've been getting a lot more questions from people, and we put out the call to see if we can do a... wow, this is a hard game. See if we can do an old audience questions show, because we love answering questions. If you want to send any questions, Ryan, you could send them to hoppedupeast@gmail.com.
Really?
Yeah. Stop doing shills.
Yeah, shill all you want. That's the point.
So what shapes?
Ooh.
What do I do to turn into a star?
You need 10.
So I got 10 before.
You get
10
and it gives you a star. And then... Let me read the instructions again.
Please help.
You get one...
Oh, wait. I just pressed V.
Oh.
So what does this do?
You get one life by becoming a star. So you have more health now, I think. So you're running out. Boom. Now you're back. So now you see your life. It's going
down. Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
Wow. Okay.
All right.
You get it?
Yeah, I got it. I think we got to see the star power.
Cool.
It's kind of like a screen clear. All right, we're going to close that. Okay, I was going to say, it's still playing in the background. cool.
All right.
That was not bad. That was fun.
I think we'll rate this one. I think we have time for maybe
one more
game.
Then we'll wrap with Mode Shift, our game, and then we'll wrap with our game. We'll blast off.
I'm going to keep this list, so I might go through and rate a few of them in my own time. It's not on stream. I'll try to give you guys some feedback. So,
Matt SJ, thank you for sharing this with us. And thank you to everyone who shared their games with us so far. Let's go down here. So, innovation. I think that's a 4 out of 5. There's some cool, fun ideas. It's like Ikaruga, except like you're slamming into things instead of shooting them.
Yeah. Seems interesting.
There's an idea there. I wonder if there's a way to expand on it. Fun. I'm going to say right now we're a little rushed for time, but I think I would find that game fun to play just in my own time. Not entirely dissimilar from Mode Shift. It's a score chaser.
Dodge things.
Theme. I don't know, man. 3 out of 5 just because they did a thing.
Yeah.
Not the most, like, this sounds overly harsh, but like, not the most inspired idea of shape shifting.
Which, I mean, this again, but this theme is not,
this theme is bad. I don't like the shape shift, like Ludum Dare theme, and I've liked very few of them. I think they should just be something, a jumping off point, rather than something we like stringently hold everything to adhering, you know, like, blech. Anyway, graphics. I actually really like that look. I know it is very simple. Actually, no, I think, sorry, I may have jumped the gun a little bit there. It might not be a 5. I think it's a very good 4. I do like it. It's kind of something kind of fun and like phosphorus arcade screen looking about it. You know, nice CRT that's like dying and breaking and just has this like these bright whites that are like just bleeding out. I like it. I like the look. Don't know what the, I don't know if your inspiration was anything like that, but cool. I like the audio.
Yeah,
it's a good little tune in
nice
the background.
Tempo,
no humor, no mood. Yeah. Not rating
again.
Those.
If you don't want to be rated, you shouldn't put them there because most people will probably rate you a 1 and then bring down your overall score.
Great looking game. Love the audio.
There you go. Matt has very in-depth comments.
Oh well, I'm making them now. I'm not transcribing them. There right, we go.
We got one more.
One more.
Someone in the chat has Knightwolf. One word, and then.
Yep. Thanks for sharing.
Knight is, oh, there it is.
Thanks for sharing your game. Knightwolf, thank you for sharing. Oh, no.
Ironhead,
thank
and
you.
And I think in the chat, his name is Trevor Johnson 1.
Trevor Johnson 1.
Which makes me think his name is probably actually Trevor.
Oh, he's the first clone of Trevor Johnson.
Yes.
The original Trevor Johnson that he was based on is going underground now, incognito, because he's let clones run amok. I clicked the download button, I thought. Did I not? Uh-oh.
There you're good. It might play it in window, but you can probably download it if you scroll down.
There it is. Is this itch.io or something? Oh, no. This is like his personal website or something.
No, this is not itch.io.
Well, it's like Wolfbane. Oh, right.
Dot itch.io. And you can theme it and stuff.
Cool.
I just never do, because...
Because you're a slacker.
Yeah, I'm a slacker.
Okay. Holy calzones. This one's 24 megabytes, Ryan. I don't know if my internet can handle that.
Our Canadian internet isn't very good. The pipes are clogged.
We're going to hit our cap, our data cap here.
If only.
Oh, boy. Well, I think we've seen a lot of games today. We did not get through our initial list, but I think it's just because there's... Sorry if we missed anyone's games, but... It's one of those things where if people are here right now watching, we'll play theirs because it's more of a communication platform. Than,
yeah, we want to give live feedback.
Yeah,
anything.
Yeah, because it's right. Oh, no, I didn't buy a WinRAR. Nobody look. Oh, gosh. The evidence. Hey, what? Come back. To the desktop because I don't give a crap. There we go. Minimize.
And I'm going to post a link in the chat here. If you guys want to submit more games that Matt or I can look at like offline, we'll try to leave some feedback.
Yeah. What was the last Unity game we did? Did it work full screen just fine?
Yeah, the Unity ones seem to be fine.
Okay. Well, while I'm waiting for this to catch up with the stream, Ryan, why don't you go ahead and just read me the controls and the info about this game?
Oh, yeah. Let me bring it up.
Because... I can't see it anymore.
Oh. You're a knight who's lost his sword. Naughty, naughty knight. And you must search a dangerous land to find it. Luckily for you, you're also a werewolf, so... That's it.
That's good.
That's it.
Any controls?
No controls. Nope. They're right at the bottom. They're very hard to read on the screen.
It's very tiny. Can you check... can you flip back over to the stream there, the monitor, and check if we're...
We're good.
We're good.
Yep.
Okay. What good is a knight without a sword? Da, 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 da. Oh boy, what's that say? Hold on, I gotta actually walk over to the screen.
Left and right arrows to move, space to jump, one key transforms to knight, two key turns into werewolf, and tap to attack werewolf.
There you go.
First criticism, please make your text bigger. That's probably a scaling thing since...
Yeah, like, if you're at a computer monitor, this would look... It'd be readable.
Yeah.
But we're about 6-7 feet away.
Yeah. You mind if I play this one, Ryan?
Go for it.
Okay. Sorry, I forgot to get the controls already. Left or right to move, one to turn into a guy, two to turn to a dog, and then tap to attack. Hey, look at that. Okay, space to jump. I'm going to turn it up a little bit here. Oh, press two to turn to a werewolf.
Oh, I thought you were the skeleton. Just, uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Ooh, got a V-sync. Or V-tearing.
Yeah, tearing. Oh, boy.
Oh, that seems... Man, I kind of like how this looks. Like, the art's pretty good. Are you bouncing?
Yeah, I'm not doing anything. What?
You turn back?
I guess.
Whoa. Can you attack as a knight?
No.
Okay.
Jesus Christ. That was violent. What happens if I just... Oh, I just pop. Okay. What happens if I die as the wolf?
You can't.
Probably. I will say this. It would be great if the transition was faster from man to wolf. Not even a sound. All right.
There's a sound.
It went...
Yeah, that's what I mean. Oh, but, you mean but like no, a yelling like, sound. Oh! You wanted a guy like impersonating a wolf?
Yeah. Is that that friggin' cat from... Is that a cat? No, that's a skeleton. Never mind. I was going to say, was that cat from that like Tom's Touch iOS game or whatever it is? Tom the Cat?
Oh, that's the one that talks back to you?
Yeah. Just from this far away, it sort of looked like that. Oh, boy.
Oh.
Daring. Whoever made our monitor.
Oh, you think?
It could be.
Whoever made this game, if you could enable VSync...
That would be
It might be a good idea, because our monitor doesn't seem to like this, but it looks good. I like it. Like, I like the drawing. Like, I like the art. I think the animation could use a few more frames, but...
Damn it. I can only assume that's your voice.
you can't die as a wolf.
I can't die as... That's a lie.
The wolf's... Well, you can't die from combat as a wolf.
No, I totally did. I ran into the guy and...
You sure? Try it.
Yeah.
He said wolf's on a timer. Timer must have changed, like,
no.
As you were on top of a guy.
No, it was not that. Okay, here, I'm just going to... All right, we're going to test your idea, Ryan. I'm going to bounce over here, and I'll turn to a wolf, and then I'll run into that guy that killed me.
They can't see the tearing on the stream as bad, obviously. So.
Okay, so it's probably us.
Yeah, it's probably this monitor, or TV, or whatever.
Yeah, no doubt in my mind. All right, I'm going to turn to him.
He said, except for zombies. The zombies one-shot you.
Okay, well then...
So the zombies can kill the wolf. You probably don't want to get hit by... Yeah, you probably have to avoid the zombies. Which is a little... From a feedback perspective, it's a little confusing because as a wolf, I'd expect to be able to just destroy the zombie as well.
Excuse me. Yeah.
I mean, I could see you if the enemy was...
Well, they're silver zombies.
A silver zombie.
Let's see if I can get further than where I was. Okay. I may have just screwed myself. I actually don't know where to go from there.
I don't know.
All right, let's try one more time.
Getting hang of this, though. Whoa. Oh, you have health.
I have health.
I like how the health's a slider bar. You use the Unity default slider bar and turn it red. I like that.
Okay.
So can you... There's no way you can make that jump. As a wolf, can you?
I don't know. Let's try. I don't think I jump any higher.
Yeah, I think the...
Oh, yeah.
I think the best way to get feedback kind of responding...
I got it.
You got up.
Yeah.
Oh. Kill him. Before you turn back. But yeah, if you want feedback, Sparrow, I think the best way is really to create an HTML5 game. Or a web game. Because I think people are a lot more likely to play it if it's that easy.
Oh, I guess I had to kill them. Cool.
We didn't create a web game for ModeShift this time because we use GameMaker. Because
Ryan's a slacker.
And, well, no. I'm just cheap.
I'm kidding.
And I don't have the HTML5 export.
Oh, it's like, what, $200-something?
It's like $200.
Oh, yeah. I definitely jump up further, at least.
Oh, geez, yeah. You have a lot more air control. Well, maybe not control, but...
It's more
air velocity.
Oh, boy. All
right. So the wolf turns off eventually, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Just go for it. Wait, what'd that say?
I don't know. Oh, those are zombies. Those are zombies.
Oh, you're dead. Wait, what?
Oh. Nah, right. Yeah, I'm dead. All right, I think we got to stop here because we are quickly running out of time. But thank you for sharing. Nightfall? What was it? Knightwolf.
Knightwolf by Trevor Johnson.
He says
he's the original Trevor Johnson.
The original. Okay. The only thing, well, actually, we can talk about it right here. We've got...
thank you for removing a bunch of categories.
Wow, yeah.
Thank you.
This is the first one we've seen that is noticeably... took graphics off there, I see. I would love to talk about them just for 1 second. Obviously, you have a look sort of that you're going for. Your animation, some good spots, some spots that could be improved, I think. Yes. Like the wolf, he doesn't have a jumping animation. The knight does. I'm sure it was just a time thing. But it's always great to make sure, you know, all key parts of the game, if it's something you're interacting with a lot, like a jump or something, is always great if you can. But yeah, I don't know. Let's look down here and see what they want to be talked about. Innovation.
I didn't really see anything necessarily. It was a pretty standard platformer.
Yeah, platformer with a shifty mode.
Power up, technically, I guess.
Yeah. Would be lovely to be able to switch quicker between the two modes, and then that way you'd be able to like do more dynamic stuff. Maybe
like I've seen games that do transformation, whereas the first transformation will be slow just to kind of have an effect and show something, and then the subsequent ones be a lot faster or skippable.
Yeah, and a great example of how a transformation done quick can result in incredible mechanical opportunities. There's two examples: Outland on the Xbox and I think PS3. Xbox 360 and PS3 was a downloadable game that was basically like Ikaruga, but a Metroidvania thing. And you would hold, I think, one of the bumpers or something. You'd go from red to blue, and then that would allow for like combat with different kinds of enemies that you had to be like very cognitively aware of, and like spaces you could move through. And then the other example being something that basically does that same thing, except in a different kind of game, DMC, the latest Devil May Cry.
Oh, yes.
Where like you have the blue and the red, and like you can engage with certain parts of the environment or certain enemies with certain weapons and modes, and even just like the same weapon with a different color, like the grapple or whatever. Like when it's blue, it's a pull, and the red, it's a throw or something or whatever it was.
Yeah, and even like games
you go to them or they go to you. That's what it was.
Yeah, and even games like Bloodborne with the shift, like transforming weapons, the shape-shifting weapons, you can shape-shift mid-combo to increase your moveset and do special things.
So like getting that transform time down can always lead to more opportunity to explore ideas.
Somebody wanted to know what we thought of Dark Souls.
Which one?
The first, second, or third one. You can respond to that, and we'll continue.
Well, okay, with this. Yeah. When we talk about mode shift, I'll talk. I don't know. I love Dark Souls. I haven't played number 3 yet, but I put 3 down for fun.
Yeah, I wasn't playing, but it looked like it was fine.
It's all right. It's again one of those things where like we gotta. It feels like we're still like a little bit of teaching, not able to explore all the ideas and all that stuff. So it's not something I would be addicted to or go back to or anything. But I could definitely see maybe. You do some stuff, and it might be pretty neat. Theme, shape-shifting, I guess you're a wolf.
You do, yeah.
Do we want to do 3 or 4? 3 or 4, what do we want to do?
Let's give it 4. I'll give you 4 because you trimmed out a bunch of categories.
Yeah, there we go. Mood. N-A.
Yeah, no mood. I don't know. We don't like that one. Yep, sure.
Yeah, because you took out a bunch of categories that we would have probably rated you higher in.
Yeah, even though you don't have it in here, I think the graphics were great. Maybe you removed it because you didn't do it yourself, but you made great choices.
Curation is a set of skills that should be respected. Anyway, I'm going to just say great game. Great game. Thanks for sharing it. Sharing it with us. Here we go. And I'll put a smiley face.
Cool.
And then I need to go back here and turn the stream back on because when I hit the smiley face, like the closed parentheses on the smiley face, it made it go black.
That's just annoying.
That's because we're using the broadcast machine. Yeah.
You're not supposed to.
Not supposed to.
Sparrow, the YouTube account, look up Hopped Up Gaming East.
Yep, on YouTube, and that's where the archive will be sometime next week. Maybe I'll get Ryan to like tweet it out.
And if you follow me on Twitter at Ryan Nielsen, same as my my Twitch name, I'll tweet it out sometime this week.
Fun. Okay, I think that brings us to the end of our show here, and we're gonna send her off with perhaps just a little demonstration of our little game called Mode Shift.
Ryan, I'm going to let you play it first because you're bad at video games.
I am terrible. I'm using a controller.
Yeah.
Wait, don't start the game until I have the controller on because I don't know.
No, I think it works fine.
Oh, really?
I think you figured it out how to make it work without needing that on first. It's not a Unity game, so.
That's true.
So we're going to do it this way because I don't want to do weird screen capture stuff.
Yep.
I'm going to bring down the audio just a little bit. So mode shift. Ryan, do you want to talk about mode shift for a second?
Yeah, so mode shift, it's pretty simple. It's a side scroller shoot 'em up, I guess, in the vein of those old games in the arcade and on the NES. It's mostly about surviving, so we score you based on time, so you want to live for as long as possible. And we have a few kind of mechanics in the game. The main ones are basically collecting experience dropped from enemies to upgrade your weapons, which makes you shoot faster. And that bar actually depletes over time, so you kind of have to keep running in, getting experience, running out, surviving. Makes it a little more complicated, adds a little more depth, makes it a little more interesting, in my opinion. And we also have a shape-shifting move.
Oh, what's it called?
Mode shift. And that makes your ship shoot up and down, so you shoot vertically or horizontally.
Ryan, you hear that? That's the mechanics police calling.
Yeah,
they're coming to arrest us for stealing that from a lot of games.
It's about time.
Actually, it was an ambulance. By ambulance.
Okay, so yeah, I mean, the best way to demonstrate this is just to show it off, I guess.
Get into
it. Just pay attention to this pretty cool title screen because I'm pretty proud of it.
I helped make it.
You ready? Ready?
Oh, man, you just came out of hyperspace, dude.
So you get into it. The enemy spawns are randomly generated. They pick up over time. We have a few types of enemies with different patterns, so.
Hey, different kinds of deaths.
And different kinds of
asteroids that break apart.
Break apart horizontally or vertically.
No, they do that, but they also go diagonally.
they do go diagonally too. UFOs, like these guys are the worst, and they just fly into the screen, and then they pick a spot and they fire out bullets in all directions.
That high score of 100.92 seconds is mine. I apparently don't have the world record anymore, but I refuse to acknowledge somebody in the chat who didn't send a
screenshot. Yep. These enemies, the UFOs, the smaller ones, just kind of move across the screen shooting at you. These satellites move in sort of a sine wave up and down pattern. The rockets move straight. That's the main enemies. As you can see, they kind of get faster and it gets more hectic the further you go.
Yep, but you're collecting
You're collecting E, which is energy. And if you look at the bar on the top right, you can see it filling out. I don't know if the ticks show on the screen, but there's a tick on every third of the bar. And then when you fill up beyond that point, your gun actually picks up its firing rate. So it becomes kind of insane eventually.
Yeah. If you're not at third level by 30 seconds,
it gets pretty rough.
Might be in trouble.
And you can see how the energy doesn't move. The idea behind that was we didn't want you to hide in the back and just go like this, up and down.
Yeah, that's going to run out. Yeah,
so we added the energy staying in place, and we added the depleting bar to kind of counter players doing that.
Yeah.
So they have to constantly move up, get energy, run back. And we balanced around that. And that might have actually been the best I've ever done.
Yes.
I'm pretty proud of myself.
Yes. Why don't you do another run while I talk about this?
Yeah, sure.
An interesting component that we discovered about like the forcing people to move up and down, I don't remember when it was introduced in the development. I know the mode shift component, like flipping up and down, was extremely late.
Yeah, we're like, oh, we need shape shifting. Oh, crap.
Okay, it was very late, but it ended up working out quite well because it's one of these things of like when you build a game around random generation, you want to give the players the means to counteract poor generation, let's call it, or unfair generation in a sense. It's not that like the game is unfair at times, but it's like sometimes it sticks you in an unadvantageous situation, and to counteract that, like having another tool in the arsenal, the ability to shoot up and down as opposed to only from left to right, helps a lot, because in conjunction with the E not moving and having to navigate on that side of the right side of the screen, you might find yourself like, oh no, I have to move backwards to shoot people, I've gone too far, and that's just not fun. Whatever. So being able to shoot up and down really kind of like helps feel like you can mitigate problems or do two things at once or be efficient or not defenseless one on the right of the screen.
Yeah, I mean, if I'm in the back of the screen too and I see two enemies above and below me, I can pop into vertical shooting, kill them both, and then I have a lot of experience right there.
Now, you're probably asking why. Well, okay, that makes sense in some way. Why would you not have them shoot up and down and when you flip forward and backwards? And I think that's something that we didn't really have a lot of time to explore, and we just went with like the gut feeling and decision, you know, around the comet of like, well, if we do that, then you lose this sense of space relative to everything. But at least this is the way I thought about it. So you're moving from left to right, and if you can shoot back and forward and up and down, then you really you almost become this, I don't know what the right way to describe it, is like you decentralize from the whole space, like it loses its relativity, and you're just navigating a rectangle now, and it doesn't matter, you know, where you are on the map, you're effective. And then that gets into a problem where we have everything come from the right side of the screen.
Yeah, we really balanced and built around the idea of everything coming from the right.
Yeah, so if you could do, if you could interact efficiently on any part of the screen, like that would
be a different game.
Game, and we could build a game like that. But I think in its current state, not being able to shoot backwards is okay, because the game is built around that, and also does, you know, it does maintain this idea of like you're moving somewhere, you're going somewhere, and then, you know, in the dumb story, it's like you're trying to just, you're going to defend Earth Gov's like, yeah, evacuation kind of, efforts.
That's our something. Little story.
And there's a little story in there. So like you should be moving, you should be propelling somewhere. So I don't know if that makes sense to anyone in the chat, but
someone sent a screenshot though.
Oh, you? I don't.
You think that's doctored?
Yeah, I might. I don't know.
All right, Kappa, you win.
Fine.
You win.
I concede. Well, except, why don't you hand me the controller, Ryan? It's my turn.
There you go. All right, let's show me how a master does.
Get ready to lose your high score, bud. I'm going to win. Oh, God, this is nuts.
It's bad positioning. Bad spawns.
Bad spawns, Ryan. This isn't fair. He had easy spawns, or she, whoever, this person.
This game can get kind of insane if you get, like, two or more of those giant UFOs on the screen. You're screwed.
Alright, this is it. High score. Going down.
Yeah, I acknowledge the victory of the 158 seconds, or 56 seconds. Matt does not. He thinks it's doctored.
I saw nothing.
Matt's a Photoshop expert, so he can see the pixels that are changed.
I could tell from the shadows.
Yeah, the shadows and...
There are no shadows in this game. Oh, you dicks. Well done. 156 seconds is quite a long time. Yeah.
You're a pretty good killer. Especially if that was one of your first times playing.
Well, if it's one of his first times playing, either he is a you know, brilliant video gamist or got really lucky.
What is that app you can use to hack PC games and cheat?
Cheat engine.
You use cheat engine.
Yeah, he turned the spawns to zero.
Or you just modified the high score in memory.
Ryan, we gotta get VAC ban defense or whatever on this. Like, you gotta make sure nobody's cheating, ruining the integrity of the community's high scores.
I know, it's such an important. I'm doing way better than you.
Listen, my high score is printed on the friggin' screen, bud. I've done
maybe
way
you
better
use cheat engine.
Don't even dare insinuate that. I have a reputation to uphold of being better at Halo than you, being better at Mode Shift than you, and being better at Party Boat than you.
Well, yeah, you got that one.
Yeah, I got that one. I'm terrible at that game. Not a lot of people play Party Boat, I think. I'm the best at Party Boat because I can beat it. That's a hard as hell game. A lot of the games we play or design end up being score-based.
Yeah, there's a very... time-based. We have a... Yeah, style,
we have a poor tendency to do that.
I like these kind of games, and I like action games, and it's a lot easier in a game jam to generate things or make games that have random generation, and you don't have to create more content because we're already kind of stretched with me programming everything and Matt doing art and sound. It's tough.
We're kind of, yeah. Not even, it's at a certain point, it's also like mental energy to continue doing
anything. Yeah, there's
anything.
That too. But like, by the time Sunday comes around,
it's like, I want to die, I want to go. Because
this is a jam game, but we try to stick to the compo timeline.
Yeah.
So we try to do it in 48 hours because we both have day jobs and we can't quit work on or not go to work on Monday.
We also like to do things besides like not shower and program and draw. Yeah.
You get kind of stinky after 2 days.
Yeah. And you also get sick of eating pizza or pita chips or whatever you bought.
Doritos.
I ate a whole bag of Lay's chips this time. That was my only snack.
Yeah, like one night.
That was so... it made my mouth so friggin' dry.
It's full salt.
I know, but I didn't remember them being that salty. It's been so long since I had Lay's chips and like they weren't even that tasty. I kind of regret it, to be honest. I don't think I'll get them again for a long time, or at least until I forget how disappointing it was.
H2, we made this game in Game Maker. I usually use Unity, and I prefer Unity for the most part. But I wanted to give Game Maker a try for a game jam, because I haven't yet.
Well, I think with that loss there, we'll just go back to the title screen and look at my nice 100.92 seconds.
Check that out by Kappa.
You did
That's
not.
That's a very legitimate score.
That's very legitimate. 99.0 seconds. Well done. You're way better than me. I guess that's it. That's our game. We would love for you to go check it out. You can check out any of the other ones we've done, too. Not that you can, like, rate those, but maybe you have some fun with them. Some of the ones we made, like Murder Dome. Is Murder Dome on here?
I can check.
Okay, it's all right. It's one of those. Now, dime a dozen inspired by nuclear throne shooters that we had a lot of fun with. There's also, if you search Ryan Nielsen on itch.io.com or .co, what is it?
itch.io.
Itch.io, Ryan Nielsen. You'll find where a bunch of the other games he and I have worked on and some of his own individual works. And you can have some fun times with Tunnel Run, if that still works there. I don't know.
They should all still work, as far as I know. So ryannielsen.itch.io.com.
Yeah. You can also check out The Cost of Living that's on there exclusively, I think. Because that didn't get submitted to...
we submitted that.
To
some weird itch.io game jam.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what it was. That's a fun multiplayer game. I like that. There's one thing you can do to not make it fun, but don't do that.
If you have a bunch of controllers, play The Cost of Living. Yeah. It's on itch.io. I'll post a link in the Twitch channel.
Yeah, post a link there. Check out that stuff. It's fun. And also, hey, you know, this is a cross-promotional kind of in collaboration, testing for live show stuff with Hopped Up Gaming East. Check out the Hopped Up Gaming East podcast, an East Coast podcast of a West Coast podcast about beer and video games and fun things. It's an alright show. I'm on it, and Ryan's number one fan of it, so... And you can find the archive of this stream on the Hopped Up Gaming East YouTube channel.
YouTube Hopped Up Gaming East.
Yeah, you might get it if it's all one word. There you go.
Boom.
First result.
UC5. Don't they have short names for YouTube channels?
I might have to make that an elective. Oh. Anyway, just copy that there and paste that in the chat.
All right.
Yeah, you can find it, Hopped Up Gaming East. By punching in Google or YouTube. And I think that brings us to the end here. Thank you, everyone, for joining us for this afternoon of Ludum Dare Games. Thank you to everyone who sent us theirs, and apologies to anyone who we could not get to. Ryan might take some time, his own time, and rate and review some of your stuff. So keep sending things if you want.
Yeah, I think voting ends in 3 days, so I'll try to do everything that's in that spreadsheet. So if it's not there, just add it to the spreadsheet. There's a link on the Ludum Dare page, and I think I posted a link in the chat.
There we go. Perfect. So then I guess now we will just sign off. Thanks everyone for joining us in the chat on the stream and sending your games. We've had a blast. I hope you have as well. Ryan, did you have a blast?
I had a lot of fun. It was great.
Perfect. Then I think we'll blast off.
Yeah, and maybe we'll see you guys next Ludum Dare.
Have a great day, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.